goes through. And all right, so that's good. Any word on Crystal?
She said she was on her way, so like 9:30. So yeah, she'll terrible. Get here like 11 or some shit.
It's pretty bad out there. Of course, I have flood warnings.
Just make sure it's on the Facebook Live.
This is the top four.
Good morning, good morning. It's great to stay up late. Good morning to you.
Wake up!
You are now listening to the Sunday Morning Breakfast Radio Show.
Good morning, good morning. It's the Sunday Morning Breakfast Radio Show coming to you live from Facebook Live, Twitter, and YouTube Live. The number to call in, 516-900-2278. This is the Weekend Review Show, and we do this every Sunday from 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. only on Facebook Live. Follow us, facebook.com/Sunday Morning Breakfast Radio. We have the usual suspects in studio, although we do have one missing. No, to be fair, it is really nasty outside in New York City, so, you know. All I have to say is, though, before I make the introductions of everyone here, it is hoodie season, people.
What?
Round of a freaking applause.
Nah, it's been all summer. Summer took a leave of absence.
I don't think if anybody follows the show and knows me in particular, I love hoodies. Sweatshirt and hoodies is the go-to.
Particularly dirty ones.
Yes, exactly. So,
where has Preach been for the past August? It's like been this for like the whole entire
No,
August.
It hasn't.
It was cold, B.
Now, we got summer, but we didn't get like heat wave, sweaty breath. No, but it's been summer.
Yeah.
Okay, we say hoodie in the night then. Yes.
I can't call
you're
it.
You're such a Caribbean. Hoodie in the night. In August and July. What are you talking about?
We have Bino in studio. How are you doing, Bino?
What's good, everybody? Everybody good?
Good. How's voices here as well? Voice, yes. How are you, sir?
I'm trying to get better. I was sick all this
week. It is. We're all missing Crystal's on her way. We're missing her at the moment, but she'll be here pretty soon. Like I mentioned, it is kind of crazy out there. It's also Juve today, so.
That's not.
Let's hope she survived.
Actually, Juve is at 6 o'clock in the morning. They canceled the night. You can no longer go in the night anymore.
It's not in the night anymore?
Nope. 6 o'clock tomorrow morning.
That makes sense. Mm-hmm. Even though you'll still have the knuckleheads in Brooklyn.
I love to say what y'all think. Killing takes. Killing goes to sleep. Like, what's wrong with y'all?
Oh, yeah. Damn it. All right. I'm going to go to bed early. Yeah. So it's a shout out to everybody on the thread as well. Good morning to those people who are watching us.
Was good, Antoine. Was good, Leroy. Carol. Hello, Carol Ross. Yes.
Hello, everybody. How was everybody's week? We had last week off. It was the birthday of Mace Face. So yes. I had to
shout
make
out
a trip
to
out
happy
to Delaware.
Birthday. Belated.
Yes. Thank you for that. How was everybody's week? Well, 2 weeks.
No, mine was depressing.
You're feeling
mine
under the weather.
Yes.
Depressing. What was depressing about?
Because I was under the weather.
You still found time though to post pictures of yourself shirtless though.
Yes, that was prior to me getting sick. That was the last week, and then afterwards
it couldn't happen earlier. Jesus Christ. How was your week, B? How you been, man?
I'm good, man. Thanks for asking.
No, you know,
it's the face concern. Wow, you've been everything good?
Did everybody was everybody able to catch the fight?
Yeah.
Yes. What'd you think of it?
Yeah, it was better than I thought, actually. Yeah,
absolutely, yeah. I would agree. Yeah. I would definitely agree. What did you notice from the fight?
I noticed a lot of things from the Diaz fight. He was getting tired. And once I saw the wobbly legs, I was like, he's about to be gone.
Yeah, well, he was tired by round four.
Which is crazy. I understand it, though, because UFC, you don't have that many rounds. But right. I didn't think he was going to.
I just feel like he didn't train as a boxer. No. He continued training as an MMA fighter. And they only go.
A boxing match.
Absolutely. Yeah. And I think MMA matches only go for 5 rounds. Is that correct?
I think 6.
I think it's 5, but whatever. It's either way. It's still not 12.
Yeah, so, no, no.
I noticed a lot of proud to be an Americans were on the Irish side there.
Wait, there was a lot of converts.
I don't know what that's about.
Yeah.
You think it was a race issue?
Come on, man. Don't do that. It's too early.
They had pubs that said Conor McGregor on it.
Yeah, I mean, there's a lot of Irish pubs in New York City that also...
Yeah, but you love America first, yes? Okay.
I'm not touching that, man. I'm not doing anything with that.
I see the homie Trini Man on the thread.
Yes. By the way, so thank you for mentioning that. So Trini Man has been quite popular since his appearance a couple weeks ago on our show, okay? So should we play this?
Cause no, we're not gonna play it. Cause we need permission first.
Oh, we do.
We do need permission first. He told me to keep that on the.
Oh, under, really?
Maybe what I should have mentioned that before the show started.
Yeah, but I love the theme then so the much. We'll play. We'll play it during the break, and then we'll deliberate on whether we can play it.
I can't.
It's a great
the world premiere of Trini Man the remix.
Trini Man has a theme.
Trini Man has a new theme.
He has a new theme.
And they took our theme and remixed it.
Yes.
For Trini Man.
Well, no, it's not ours. It's your theme. You love this theme.
Well, it's his Pledge of Allegiance.
No,
yes.
But it's now Trini Man's
theme. It's now Trini Man. That's his thing now.
I do have an idea because a lot of the ladies have been asking about Trini Man.
The ladies,
mm-hmm. Yes, they want to know. They want that bull Trini head. Yes. So
what?
We will have a Trini Man dating game. If Trini Man agrees.
No, are you serious?
Yes, we'll have a Trini Man dating
game. He seems excited because that's the OMG coming up.
Yeah, he's hype, yo. He is hype.
Are you serious?
He's the one pressing the heart all along the game.
So wait a minute. So we're really setting up a dating game for Trini Man if he agrees to it.
Correct.
Now, I guess there's going to have to be some qualifications for you to be able to date Trini Man. You have to make oxtail very well.
Yes, and roti.
And roti. You have to make doubles. Yes.
You have to wear sandals everywhere.
No, with even funerals.
That's right. Yes. Correct.
You have to know your soca songs, yes.
Oh, yeah, you have to know Mighty Sparrow and War Donkey.
If we play Tiny Whiny and you don't know what the hell we're talking about here.
You can't say sense. Yes.
It's going to be crazy.
Sense dollar, then you're not part of the group. All right, so well, I'm excited for that, man. Hopefully, let's see if he has Skype, and hopefully we can patch him in and we'll talk to him directly. But listen, Trini Man has become bigger than the show. This is crazy.
Like, Dane ass shit about me and any of y'all.
Nothing.
What's up with Trini Man?
Yep. We've done this show for how many years? 4 years now? Three or four years.
Yes.
He has, leaped us.
Correct. Yes.
As far as status is concerned.
Yeah. Thank God he doesn't have a show against us at the same time.
Oh, it'd be a wrap.
Exactly.
Trini Man hour. Doubles with your friend Trini Man on Sunday morning.
Again, people agree that you and him, your version of Martin Trivia was the worst game show.
Yeah, it was terrible.
In the history of
it was hideous.
Yes.
It was hideous.
Yes.
Trini Man won and he had -300. Imagine what your score was.
Yeah, it was bad.
It wasn't my thought.
Okay.
It was bad. All right, let's get to the top five stories of the week, man.
This is the top five stories of the week. Number one.
All right, so big shouts out to everybody and all the victims out in Houston dealing with the Hurricane Harvey and the flooding, which I believe still continue. I think it's ended actually the end of this week, but it's been unbelievably sad for a lot of victims out there. And we've seen this many a times when disasters like this happen. You see everybody become, you see the greatness in people. Everybody helping out, everybody driving and sailing through floods and saving people from homes and who are being abandoned. And you always get these great stories or whatever. And then you also see the ugly. So, I mean, where do we start? First off, if you want to donate, please donate to the Red Cross.
Find some way to donate, but Red Cross be popular.
Oh, really? That's another issue I have with disasters like this. I don't know who to send money to because I'm not
directly.
Yell at Haiti, I'm not doing that. I don't know.
Hell no.
I don't know who to donate to. I guess do some research. Find out if you can find a proper charity to donate to, and possibly it'll get to the people that need the most. So, but shout out to everybody who's helping, all the victims out there, all the sports teams that have, you know, helped out a lot, all the celebrities, which I kind of don't like.
Yes.
So, yeah, Kevin Hart, do the challenge. I don't know why. Now we have to do a challenge of, all right, you have to donate $25,000.
Yep.
And then you have A-Rod and Jennifer Lopez. We're both donating $25,000 each.
Yo, that is so corny.
I donated
my little $10. I ain't have to tell the world. like it was between me and the person at Dwayne Reed. Like, yo, when you do that, but deadass, when you like got to tell the world, hi, I'm donating $25,000. Like, you're doing that for you. You're doing that to further your cause or let the world know you're a nice person or whatever.
Right.
Like, that shit is corny. And Master P called Kevin Hart out for that.
Right, right. Just do it. And, I mean, nobody, why put a label on it? I don't understand.
Nobody has to know.
What's the point? What's the point? So I don't get that. And then you had the big name this week with this whole hurricane situation, Joel Osteen. So who was the famous $50 million preacher who apparently had his church. And as we speak of Joel Osteen, we have the slay one, which I'm feeling
love
that shirt.
Love the shirt.
That's a dope shirt. We have the slaying and praying one in studio. Let's let her settle in. There you go. Take your time. It's okay.
Have theme music already.
No, we don't know. You can't be late and have theme music too. Like, get out of here. How you doing? You got
to
talk.
Would you like to?
Mike's your friend.
I know. Man, we look so professional. We have my sister in studio today, right?
Your sister and our new engineer here.
Yeah.
What kind of shit show you got right there?
What in the hell is going on here?
Oh my god!
You can't be on time.
Your sister's gonna give you quite the lecture.
Back from where? Where'd you go?
I went to Curacao.
Oh, really? How'd that go?
It was amazing.
And you have people in a flood in Houston.
I am sober.
I just have to check. You know, we have to make sure you're okay. We care about you, man. Unbelievable.
So as we should get set off, we'll talk about the Joel Osteen situation. So he had his mega church, and he was getting called out because a lot of communities, a lot of buildings out there, if they had space, if there was no significant damage, they were letting people sleep. Victims who were uprooted from their homes, they were using their buildings
you
as
have a local guy who owned like a bed store,
right?
Who let everyone come in and lay on the beds and all that.
Wow. And you have Joel Osteen. Everybody knows who Joel. He's worth millions. Preaching the word. Sells millions of books. Very popular. And everybody was wondering, well, why isn't your megachurch open? Your megachurch that can seat about 16,000 people? Why isn't it open? Mm-hmm. And so speculation was coming out, well, maybe it was flooding. There was some damages. Thus why they couldn't open it. And then people had gone there. Took some pictures and said, there's no flood around here.
What kinds of dry carpet?
Absolutely. And so, yes. Miraculously, the next day, I guess after all the backlash he was getting from it, he decided to open the doors. What was the excuse he gave, though?
He said, y'all didn't ask.
Oh, that's what it was.
All you had to do was ask.
Oh, yes. I thought the Lord would ask you. You don't think the Lord comes down from above and says, Joel, can you open up the megachurch for the people?
He said, the Lord said, wait till y'all niggas ask first, and then I'm going to open the door. Yeah, I'm not just going to open the door willy-nilly. That's
right.
What he said.
Oh.
Correct.
Now, the religious person in here, the truly religious person in here, you are wearing a Presley hat, so like that's a fair label, correct?
Okay, I am more spiritual than I am religious, but I understand what you're saying. And I've met Joel
smooth criminal moonwalk are you doing right now?
No, I'm not okay. Backing up for my Christianity.
So what is your view on this whole situation?
I'm gonna be very honest with you guys. I was so disappointed. Okay. You better put that water down. Put the water down. I was so disappointed in what I thought Joel was doing. I did not follow up with the story. Because it just didn't seem right to me. There's no way that you have a mega church that big. Now, this is a man, I like Joel. I mean, I've stood in line in Barnes & Nobles to have him sign my book. Like,
did you have to ask him to sign it?
No, he signed it.
Oh, so.
And I had on this hat.
You paid for the hat?
I love this hat.
He loved the hat?
He loved the hat.
Did you pay for the book?
I did pay for the book.
Oh, you did? Oh, so then you're good.
I did pay for the book.
Oh, that's why he signed it.
So, my whole thing is, your money comes from the congregation. It comes from people who watch your services who aren't even a part of your congregation. You are for the people. You should have automatically. No. What I'm saying is.
In general, yes.
In general.
In his terms.
He should have opened up that church before anyone asked him to do it. And even if you're saying it's flooded, why wasn't there any type of notification? Like, listen, it's flooded. Once it's not flooded and we fix it, why, you know, I'm going to have these people in here. Like, he did nothing.
Right.
He did nothing.
Pay at the door.
And then somebody was on the radio saying, well, you know what? Like, he shouldn't have opened it because people like that steal. Don't worry about that. That's not for you to worry about.
Mm. It's insured.
I can't lie. He definitely didn't want his church looking like the New Orleans thing.
Right.
He started watching them Katrina videos
That's not happening to my church. You know how much I pay for this? How much is he worth? He's worth millions,
He's
correct?
He's worth a couple million, yeah.
Oh, right now.
Maybe the church like 12 alone is million worth, or something.
Church alone grosses $77 million a year.
Yeah.
Wow.
A year.
Wow. I mean, listen. Will this damage his reputation? Are his followers still gonna go to service and praise him? What do you believe?
Yeah, no one. That ain't gonna stop.
That's
my show.
Even make, that, that's what makes that's it worse.
That's not gonna stop a show.
This is an attack on.
It's not.
I don't want to attack religion. Okay.
But look at Trump. Trump still has a lot of supporters. It's sometimes people don't care what you do. They're still gonna support you because so whatever you say people? Is word.
What does that say about people?
I mean, it's sheep and followers. It is what it is.
Exactly.
That's sad. That's sad. And then you
so let me read some of these comments.
Yeah, go ahead. I'm sorry.
Okay. So what's good, Bakari? Bakari says they show pics of his church flooded, parts of it, not all.
Mm-hmm.
Carol says he said it was inaccessible.
Was it doctored?
Trinimon says he's worth $70 million.
$70 million, yes. No, he's actually, it went down. Is that $60 million?
It went down.
Oh, $60 million.
He had a bad year.
Well, that changes things.
Yes, yeah, a lot.
Maybe he needs to ask the Lord for more money.
Yeah,
get out of here. And then you had.
Did y'all see the video? I'm sorry. Did y'all see the video of him when he actually had the people in the church? He looks so bitter.
He has his arm crossed.
I was about to say, if you could see his hands, they were tied behind his back. He's so bitter.
Yeah.
Y'all better not mess on up in here.
Oh, my God.
And then you had the situation on CNN. Now, listen, I have a lot of sympathy for all the victims that are going through a lot right now. But there was this one situation where a woman was on CNN, and a lot of people were praising her because she reacted in a certain way to the media after this, you know, unfortunate situation. So let's play this video right now.
Wait, turn off the Facebook feed.
Bear with us for 1 second.
Live radio.
I know, live radio.
These live things radio. Happen, B. I'm about to start humming in the meantime. Y'all want to hear something? Any requests?
And in any day now. There we go. All right, here we go. So let's play this video. So this was a woman who was uprooted from her home, and she was interviewed on CNN. Go ahead.
Some folks there right now, including a little girl who I guess has to deal with all of this as well. What can you tell us?
Let me introduce you to Danielle here. Danielle, you just arrived. Share with us how you were rescued.
Some guys had called our phone and asked us where we were. We was waiting for the police for like 36 hours and they never came. And we was waiting at the home. We did the white flags and everything and nobody came. But then somebody had called the phone after we decided to leave the house and we had walked to the gas station with the kids. And then they had called and came and picked us up. But we had been there like 5 days with no food and no lights and nobody came. Like nobody came.
Now you're with your children. We've heard of stories of mothers trying to save their children from the rushing waters. Can you tell us how that was?
4 feet of water to go get them food on the first day. Yeah, that's a lot of shit.
Oh.
But y'all sit here, y'all trying to interview people during their worst times. Like, that's not.
Pause it right there, please.
I have an issue with that.
Thank you very much.
I have an issue.
What is your issue with that, Crystal?
My issue is when she said, "Excuse me, can I talk to you for
a second?" Exactly.
You could have said no.
Thank you.
You could have said no. What are you talking about?
Oh, hold on. Isn't it more fun to say the shit word on air and embarrass CNN? Isn't it more fun?
That was the only motive?
Yeah, like you.
You're mad. Why are you mad at CNN when you agreed to be interviewed by CNN?
You
could tell from the clip, she was standing there. Which means it wasn't like she was walking through on footage and they stopped her or grabbed her and said, "Hey, you mind talking to us?" Obviously, there was some pre-preparation. She was standing there with her kid. They had to have asked her, "Hey, do you mind being interviewed by us?" She had to have said yes because she was standing there.
Waiting
and then you're
patiently.
Mad. Then you're mad about them asking you questions.
But then you clearly said, "Okay, this is what I did the first day. I had the white flags. Nobody came." Now all of a sudden you're upset. Look at her face.
She has every right to be upset.
I think she's explaining the story. She's getting upset.
She's getting more. But here's the thing: they warned the people. I understand there's probably no way that you can escape, but you were in advance notice. You were told not to write this out. You also were told if you are going to write this out, you might as well just write your social security number
on your arm.
Right.
So they told them. So the expectation was that this result was going
to
happen.
Right. So she was surprised that she was being asked a question, even though she agreed to answer questions?
Hey.
Unbelievable.
I'm not knocking her.
Like, right. I'm not knocking the fact that she's upset. I'm knocking the fact that she waited there to speak to her, and then you get upset. Like, no.
You got mad.
And first of all, they said that she just came in there. Why are you stopping for interviews? She be looking for a bed and some food for your kids or something. You just got in there.
Priorities.
I'm just saying, I agree with you wholeheartedly. I don't understand why you're upset. I get it. You've been through a traumatic experience and we can never take that away from you. But you, then you also can't lash out at the media because you agreed to do an interview.
Hey, y'all, I'm here for her lashing out, B. I'm
here for her.
Hell, what y'all talking about? I'm here for it, B. I wish the baby got involved too.
She got something to say herself. She got something to say. Look at her face.
Oh, man. A lot of people on the field are asking, how do we feel about the fact that Trump came to see victims?
Well, let's get to number two. Let's get to number two because that's obviously the next.
Yeah.
Number two. So Trump is making his rounds. You know, doing the presidential thing, I guess. He's, you know, it was a little bit awkward, and I don't know what you guys feel about this, when he first went to Texas after the devastation and said, "What a great turnout this is." I didn't know it was a rally. I had no idea this was like a concert. But
he's definitely a weirdo.
Yeah. So
he'd been a weirdo.
But
yeah.
But like the ego is crazy. Like, how is it about you even in time of despair?
And
to where you mentioned the numbers.
Right.
And you're standing in the middle of a flood yourself. Like, what are you talking
and
about?
And he changed hats during a press conference. That he's selling them. Yeah. That he's selling on his website.
So somebody's watching the hurricane coverage. Ooh, stylish.
First, I think he had like a white one on, that he had a red one on. Like, right. He changed it in the same press conference. Like, you over here having a wardrobe change in the middle. Like 11 o'clock hour, come for a new outfit.
That's a good idea, though.
Okay.
But anyway, go ahead.
No, I just, what are your thoughts on essentially, you know, his actions after this devastation? Because we always... Obviously, Katrina was such a major event that had gone on, and it fell so much on President Bush.
Other people might
have thought it was Obama at the time, but
yeah,
no.
Shout out to them.
Yeah, shout out to them, right? But, you know, what do you feel, how has he done in a test of a disaster like this?
He was supposed to be there.
Right.
I know people didn't want him there. He had to be there. As president, he had to be there.
Right.
Now, some of the stuff he pulled while he was there is definitely questionable.
Right.
But he's supposed to be there. He's the leader of this country. He has to be there.
Right. And like, just like I was saying, it's funny. So some Trump supporters are kind of taking shots at Obama on Twitter, because apparently Obama had something to do, or he did nothing, or he was playing golf while Katrina was going on. Let me read some of these quotes.
Katrina, right?
Yeah. So they said Donald Trump isn't playing golf like Obama during Katrina. Obama played golf for a whole week before doing anything after Katrina hit. Will you please get lost? Where were you when Katrina hit? Oh, right, playing golf. Now you want to play president? Never again. Would you like to inform them when Katrina what administration was in office?
Katrina happened, what, 2005?
Yes.
That would be Bush.
Mm-hmm. That was President Bush. What the hell are they talking about?
When he flew over to assess the damage and never stopped by.
Right.
Yeah.
And waved down to the people. Right. You know what I like about this, though? It shows you how uninformed some Trump supporters are.
Right.
Like, that's it.
Right.
It's almost not worth arguing with them if they're this uninformed about what happened.
I agree with you.
And then, of course, the internet, they start mentioning other events that Obama was responsible for. The Great Depression. Slavery. You know, all that good stuff. You know what I mean?
Right.
And I'm here for it, B.
Oh, boy. And then, this week, Trump pardoned that racist sheriff out in Arizona, Chuck Arapo. Who was convicted of violating the Constitution for illegally searching immigrants and, well, black and brown people out in Arizona, suspecting them of being illegal.
But the best thing is he did it on a Friday night.
I know.
Because he thought that the news would, like, overtake what he did. You know what I mean? Like, oh, no, I'm just going to pardon this racist.
Listen, now, I've never called Donald Trump a racist. He does have some racist tendencies, though.
Right.
Like, this is...
Then what would you call a person who has racist tendencies?
Almost a racist.
Almost, I guess. Almost.
Like a Diet Cola of racism? Like, but, what would you say?
One calorie?
Right, you have to give it to him. He did make hints that he was going to do it.
No, we knew it was going to happen, absolutely.
We knew it was going to happen.
His explanation for it was the fact that he is over 80 years old. Mm-hmm. He served this country for about 40 years. He deserves to be pardoned. I would ask that same question about Bill Cosby. All those people who want Bill Cosby locked up, they said, well, he's over 80 years old. They didn't care. They want him still locked up. Apparently he raped women. So his age shouldn't matter. He should still do time, right?
How many people at this table think that Bill did it?
Bill what? Bill Cosby did? What
a left turn. I mean, come on. Come on. I put my feet up too.
I got you.
I think it's pretty unanimous.
I think he set that jello on the table and went to please.
All right, let's get to number three. All right, so you had this crazy situation going on in a hospital out in Utah, of places. I don't think there are any black people in Utah. So this happened to a nurse by a cop. So here's the situation, okay? A cop wanted to take blood from an unconscious patient. Mm-hmm. I guess hospital policy, I don't know if it's countrywide, but I guess in this hospital, you're not allowed to take blood from an unconscious patient if you don't have a warrant or you don't have consent.
Correct.
So a cop was asking this nurse, give us his blood. We need to take a blood test. We need his blood. She refused. She went so far as to reading the guidelines to the officer. Mm-hmm. I believe she got her supervisor on the phone mm-hmm. to tell the officer we cannot do that. And this is what ensued.
She's the one that has told me no.
Sir, you're making a huge mistake right now.
So the supervisor tells the officer you are making a mistake.
Okay. No, we're done. We're done. You're under arrest. We're going. We're done.
All right, stop the tape.
You can't sit watch anymore?
No, I can't watch
stop
anymore.
Stop the tape. I've had enough.
I've had enough. This is enough.
You good?
I've had enough.
So Leroy says it was a policy agreed upon that the hospital and a local police in that area.
Okay, so there should have been an understanding with that cop as well then.
Thomas asks, is she black? Clearly no.
Not at all. Not at all. I get, and they have since apologized to her.
Apologized.
Yeah.
That's all.
She needs a little bit more than an apology, but so does 90% of black people out here. Like,
but what should she get? The damn key to the city?
Right, no, exactly. Right,
the
right.
No, that's not happening. But the fact that they provided the proof that we can't allow this, I got my supervisor on the phone.
Let me read a comment. Robert Jones says, I hope she joins BLM.
Probably not, though.
NLM.
Probably not. Not at all. Probably not.
Leroy says cops should lose his job. Over a false arrest?
I don't know if he should lose his job.
I can think of many things. Cops should lose their jobs over their Leroy.
It's, yes. It's so interesting he says that.
Yeah, it's very. You in particular, Leroy.
I'm just surprised that, you know, it's a situation like this, a white woman, not to put race involved with this, but yeah, there's a white nurse who was doing her job the way she was instructed to do it, and yet she still ended up getting arrested.
Witnesses.
Carol says, I'm waiting for this. She should have complied now.
Yeah, I wonder.
There was definitely some resisting there. She said no.
Yeah.
Not only that, she hurt the poor cop's feeling and ego.
Yeah.
You can't heard her distinctly say, she's the one that told me no.
You can't do that.
Because this is a word he's never heard in his life.
Nope.
He had to look it up in a dictionary to see what she was talking about.
Negative.
Oh, nope. She's not going to do it.
I've had enough.
Yo, he got mad at the phone.
That's crazy.
He tried to grab the phone.
He tried to put the handcuff on the phone itself.
I wish he caught the phone. He just slammed it against the wall.
Oh, my God.
Was he suspended?
I have no idea. I don't think he'll be fired though for this, but
no, I don't.
But it gets even interesting. Let's get to number four, please, Boris. Can we get to number four? Because we have a great commercial to show everybody. This is a beautiful commercial that we all should watch as a beautiful family in here. Okay, we have a full studio in here.
I love these.
This studio is amazing. So let's go pull up the blue racism, sir. All right, so. I didn't know blue was a race. I don't know how many of you guys knew this, but did you know there are actual blue people out here? They're actually blue.
Like, Smurfs?
No, they're actually blue people. There's actually like people that are blue. Like when you do the SATs or you're doing the census, right?
Burr.
And you're filling out what your race is, there is a blue option. I didn't know if you guys knew this. So apparently there's this thing going on across the country, especially seen by the NYPD, and it is blue racism. Play that clip of it. Play the clip. I love the music.
What do you see? Son, daughter.
Yes.
Mother.
Oh.
Father. Aunt.
Voice,
uncle.
Or should
cousin,
have been my voice.
Neighbor.
No.
Coach. Member of your church congregation.
Absolutely.
Community volunteer.
Mm.
The average person doesn't see those things that make me human. They don't even label me based on being African American, but Latino, Asian, Caucasian, and so on, they tend to see an even broader stereotype through an even more racist lens.
Right over
when
that
they look at me, they see blue.
Got the ill perm.
To be blue, I and over 700,000 brothers and sisters swore an oath to uphold the Constitution of my country, my state, and my city. So help me God. Yet, even in such numbers, I'm a minority as this strange form of racism continues to engulf the country.
Authorities believe the 25-year-old Army veteran fast-tracked his attack plans to target cops.
Don't be afraid of me! Be afraid of everybody!
Oh, my God.
Why do you stand up right back?
Now, pause it for 1 second. To be fair, we don't know where they flipped that car. We don't know if that was an actual sports parade or that was actually a protest. Just to be fair.
Okay. Right.
Let's just be fair on that. Okay, let's go. Continue.
Tonight, a community cries together, mourning the loss of an NYPD officer and single mother shot and killed at the start of her overnight shift in the Bronx.
Officer Familia was sitting in the passenger seat when she was shot in the head.
Because I am blue, increasingly, I'm vilified.
Whoa. Stop it right there. Because I am blue.
I'm vilified.
So let me get you straight. So out of nowhere, just walking around being blue, this guy's charged with second degree murder. And first to second degree
murder. That's what got those charges.
He's just being blue, minding his business.
Yes.
Nothing happened.
Nothing happened just, whatsoever.
I am blue.
Blue.
Just chilling. And this is what happens.
Yep.
Boris, please, continue
on.
Sworn to protect our community from injustice.
A brutal attack on a police officer near New York City's Madison Square Garden.
In spite of broad brush attacks, generalizations, and assumptions by college professors, politicians, community activists, merchants, and violence from people who I am committed to serving. And in spite of being afraid to proudly say in my private life that I am blue for fear of physical injury, death, or the safety of my loved ones. I too am someone's child, sibling, parent, aunt, cousin, neighbor, coach, and friend, just like you, who I have sworn to serve and protect. I too have dreams, aspirations, and a job to do.
Absolutely.
Surely we haven't lost the ability to discern the facts from whatever might arise. Surely we haven't
this
lost
is
our
hilarious.
Bill about for civil discourse.
Wait, who is he? Who are they quoting? Whoa! Wait, pause that right there.
I remain.
They quoted Martin Luther King.
Well, really he would be against
doctor.
This blue racism
right.
as well.
Weren't they the same ones? Weren't they the same ones arresting Martin Luther?
Yes.
Right.
The same ones putting their nightstick on him.
Right.
And putting the holes on them. But other than that, he's...
they were kind of helping the firefighter say, point there.
Yeah.
I'm just asking. Didn't they request the dogs? Were there blue lives that requested the dogs? I'm just asking.
So the dogs are considered blue lives.
So wait, you quote Martin Luther King, the same man who was dealing with brutality from who?
The same blue life.
Oh. I've seen enough of the video. Thank you very much. I'm good.
I can't get enough, actually.
Sorry.
I don't know what you're talking about.
And in no way are we trying to minimize the events that had happened to the dead police officer and any other police officer who's been assaulted or killed in the line of duty. In no way are we trying to minimize that whatsoever.
Not at all.
But this idea that you're now a race. You're now part of a minority. Man.
Talk about inclusion.
I know, man.
But again, all right, so if you're part of a minority, and if being a minority is not so bad after all, when a certain minority complains about things,
yeah, of course,
what's the issue?
I don't know.
Let me read some of these comments, yo. Bakari says they should be ashamed of using that officer's death to promote their agenda.
I agree.
Because here is what, and we always say this, I'm getting blue in the face saying this.
I saw what just happened.
Like what I just did.
That's right.
Yes.
Racism.
This is pretty simple. I hope that our people on the other side understand what I'm saying here. If you kill an officer, there is no doubt whatsoever you will be convicted and you could get the death penalty. You could do life in jail. We don't care because you deserve it.
Guess what, cops? They don't even have to make the jail.
No.
You can kill them yourselves and claim that they shot themselves.
Yeah.
And no one will question it.
By the way, can you name the person who killed that officer?
Hmm.
No, because we don't care because they're dead and we don't care.
Mm-hmm.
It's that simple. We're not marching for those people. Not at all. Whatsoever. What other comments are they saying?
DeAndre says you will die. as far as what we're talking
yes,
about.
Yes, of course.
Who's if you kill a cop.
Oh, of yes, course.
It's yes. not threatening us. Yes.
Oh, I'm about to say, me, I didn't do anything. I didn't, I'm a blue life.
Vicari also said F out of here, excuse me, with the pity party.
What are firefighters' lives? They're red lives?
I can't front, though. The beast between the two of them is serious. Like, well, they support each other, but when they fight,
they unite
other,
against one thing,
it's
though.
Like Bloods and Crips, like, woo.
But they do unite against one thing.
They do unite with Negroes.
Bar fights are serious.
That is fair. All right, let's get to number five because we're already, like, way off. All this blue life talk. Oh, my God. And then, yo, you guys remember Jenny Jones?
Of course.
Mm. Okay, so
love it.
You remember the case where I guess there was a show where a friend of a friend, I guess he had a crush. He had a crush on a friend, and you know he wasn't having that. I guess he felt embarrassed and decided to murder the guy. He's being released, I think, next month. A Michigan man convicted in 1995 murder of another man who expressed romantic interest in him on national TV, the Jenny Jones Show. Jonathan Schmidt was 24 years old when his acquaintance, Scott Amager, 32, revealed he was romantically interested in him during the taping of Jenny Jones. Now, we all remember Jenny Jones. It was top five Dead or Alive
and
top show.
I feel like it came on at 1 o'clock in the
afternoon.
It sure
did.
Yes, it did. Right? Was Ricky Lake at 12?
No.
Yeah. Yes, it was.
Ricky Lake was at 12.
Before Jenny Jones. I thought she was in the evening.
No.
They might have played her again in the evening, but during the day. Yeah.
So he is getting released from prison.
Wow.
22
years. He was sentenced 25 to 50 years. It's already been 22 years?
Yeah, 95.
Wow. Holy snap.
Yo, that low-key ruined that show.
Yeah.
Like, after that, the show was kind of...
Because that was, like, her stick. Like, how Maury has the paternity test.
Yeah, that was her thing. Yeah,
well, two things. That and makeovers.
Yeah.
Makeovers. And then she had the talent show.
Yeah, all those, I used to be ugly, but now look at me type shows.
Rude Jude, all that type of
shit. Rude Jude was the man. Rude Jude was the man. That was Eminem if he wasn't a rapper.
Schmitz is now 47 years old, and he was granted parole in March.
Wow, so he did that murder at 25?
Yeah.
You imagine, especially now, it's not like it is now where it's a lot more acceptable. Yeah. Back then, I'm sure he was embarrassed. He's probably expecting a hot chick. Mm. Some dude comes out. So he's definitely not excusing what he did. Mm. He was absolutely wrong, and that's why he served time. But
he's and in all actuality, he's actually young enough to start his life over. He can still have kids.
Yeah. I don't know how many people are going to see his name on a job application.
I know
and
not,
be like,
but you know what I'm saying? Like, if he wanted to do like that, he probably could. Hmm. He could.
Let's take a quick break because it's already 10:37. We'll take a quick break. When we come back, I'm apprehensive on putting this person on the train. I don't want to do it, but we have to discuss it. We'll be right back,
Sonny Boy.
We'll be right back.
Take a look under your bed. Find stuff under there? What about jobs? No? Now try your basement. There's a pair of overalls that overall you're not so into anymore. A perfectly good laptop that hasn't sat in your lap in months. And even more stuff, but still no jobs? Well, you really have both. See, stuff is defined as household articles considered as a group. Sometimes this stuff is no longer needed. Wait, no longer needed? That can't be right. Because remember those jobs you were looking for? Those are really needed, and they're the stuff inside your stuff. Even inside that winter coat that moved with you to Phoenix. Our job is to unlock those jobs, and it starts when you donate your stuff to your local Goodwill. Here's how we do it. When you donate to Goodwill, we sell your stuff to provide job training for people right here in your community. So just by teaming up with Goodwill, you help create jobs. And isn't that worth parting with the leftover keytar from your 80s cover band? Goodwill. Donate stuff, create jobs. Find your nearest donation center at goodwill.org. A message from Goodwill and the Ad Council.
Yeah, you, it's me, your heart. Listen to me. We've got to talk. High blood pressure is serious, and yours? Whoa. What happened to us? We used to be so much more active. But lately, you've been ignoring me. I know you think I'm just gonna keep ticking away forever, but you're wrong. You can do so much more to control your high blood pressure. Doing the minimum isn't doing enough. I'm under a lot of pressure and can quit whenever I want. Bet you didn't know that. But I like my job. Just treat me better. Check on me. Give me something green to nibble on every once in a while. And maybe we can do some exercise on occasion. Let's get to it. After all, we're in this together.
Listen to your heart. Don't let it quit on you. High blood pressure can lead to a stroke, heart attack, or death. Get your blood pressure to a healthy range before it's too late. Find out how at heart.org/bloodpressure.
All right, Sunday morning breakfast. Call us at 516-900-2278. I should not put that gummy bear in my mouth.
Hold on.
Oh.
You see that? We're all set. Okay.
Mm. So we just talked about you know, racism against blue lives. And here's, I want to show another video of evident blue racism. This is unacceptable, offensive on so many levels. I want to get you guys' thoughts on this. Can you play this video for me, Boris?
A police officer recorded on a patrol car camera making what many say was a racist remark has retired.
Towards the cop?
Before he could be fired.
The recommendation is to terminate his employment.
Why are we firing the cop? Of the Georgia He's a blue light.
Announced his plans to terminate Lieutenant Greg Abbott after this video of the 28-year veteran of the department surfaced.
Use your phone. It's in your lap right there.
Okay.
I just don't want to put my hands down. I'm really sorry. I'm just...
She's threatening.
You're just really wrong.
No. I've just been way too many videos of
I agree. Too many videos. Oh, whoa. Oh, whoa.
Black people. Yeah, whoa. We kill black people, right? All the videos you've seen, have you seen black people?
Oh. Whoa. Wait a minute. I thought it was. Wait a minute.
He's merely trying to calm her down.
Oh, that's what it was.
He's putting her at ease, yes.
That was a funny, sarcastic joke.
Yeah.
What are your thoughts on this? I mean, you see a blue life. I thought she was threatening him. Apparently, I was wrong. And I guess it was a sarcastic remark that he was making, or...
You know what's interesting? He got fired over this.
Mm.
So here's the irony.
Yes, please explain this.
Y'all like irony?
Yes, I love irony.
Alanis Morissette in 96.
Isn't it ironic?
Yeah, y'all like irony?
Don't you think?
Yes. Yes. So check this out.
Mm-hmm.
He gets fired for making a joke about killing black people.
You're right.
Yes?
Mm-hmm.
But if you actually kill black people and are a cop, you do not get fired.
Huh? You get desk duty.
Yo, you get a promotion.
Paid leave.
You're the goddamn commissioner. Ain't that some shit?
That's some shit.
But if you mention the evil plan to kill black people,
you get fired.
Get out of here. Just think about it.
Maybe it's an unspoken rule.
That's probably what he did. He's snitching.
He's snitching.
That's what he's doing. He's snitching. Yeah.
No, but you got to be about it. You got to be about that action.
That's what they want. They want to see more.
Yeah. Don't talk about it. Be about it.
Exactly.
Don't talk about killing black people. Kill them.
Wow.
Come on, man. Can you run that tape back a little bit? Sorry.
After this video of the 28-year veteran of the department surfaced.
Use your phone. It's in your lap right there.
I just don't want to put my hands down. I'm really sorry. I'm just...
She's trying to be all social just like while she's drunk.
But you're not black. Remember, we only kill black people. We kill black people, right?
Now, pause that. Didn't we just see a compelling video of blue racism going on in this country?
Oh, yeah.
Did we not just see that?
So my question is, did she complain on him or did somebody
who got the
review
tape?
The tape?
Where'd that tape come to be exposed in public?
It's his dashboard.
It's his dashboard. Dashboard.
They hide those things too. So hold on. How it's publicized.
But the balls to say that on your dashboard
cam.
But
this is the thing. They said he's a 28-year veteran.
Right.
So he's not getting...
No, he's been beating Negroes since...
For a long time. Now... Even though he's fired, he's still coming off with some money. He's been there for 20 years.
Of course. I don't think he was fired. I think he was forced to retire.
He retired before.
Which means he kept his pension.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. He's good money.
He's right. He's fine. He'll be okay. He'll be fine. So
he's watching us right now with his middle finger on.
Saying my blue life matters, damn it.
No worries.
It matters. I wonder, and this always reminds me of Colin Kaepernick. It always goes back to this. It always goes back to this because you know what? You had a couple other people making certain comments this week on their reaction on Colin Kaepernick, one being, now I'm going to ask you guys this question. Maybe the people who are in this room as well can put a vote in. George Foreman referred.
I'm sorry.
How about you?
Let him finish. I apologize.
George Foreman this week.
Goddamn cool.
Let's try again. Let me try this again.
I'll wait.
All right, George Foreman. Who we all grills and all.
Yes.
The grill.
Hey, Jay Lex.
Yes. George Foreman this week referred to Colin Kaepernick as a loser, sore losers. And everybody who's protesting, he refers to them as sore losers.
Your vote, sir?
George. Where do I begin here?
Yeah.
Go ahead, boys. I
was going to say all those blows to the head got him not thinking clearly.
Now, let me ask you a question. Does medical condition affect your vote for Kuhn Train?
No.
Because he was, I mean, he did
get
he
got blows to the head. Muhammad Ali got a lot of blows to the head, too. And he was about that action. Okay, no,
fair enough.
Muhammad Ali was really sick.
Right, exactly.
Okay, so what do you say? Even though you've said it already three times.
Please, yes, exactly.
Okay, we're going to put him on the train? Voice, you put
absolutely.
Him. Okay. Crystal?
He could go.
Okay.
But my thing is, can we stop with the damn accent. My thing is about what are we losing?
Colin Kaepernick's just a sore loser. I don't know, because... I don't know. He's just referring to them as sore losers.
So we should embrace white supremacy?
I guess so. I'm not really sure necessarily. I'm a little unsure about that. But
the cool train is getting really crowded.
It's getting crowded. We gotta add another cart.
That's fine.
Here's a tough one, too. Now, this man, who I'm going to mention, was in the front line of the struggle. We admire this person. This guy has been utmost respect, okay? And then we also did some research. I'm sorry. This is why he referred to it. Let me go back to the George Foreman situation. So he praised Trump, by the way, and he slammed Colin Kaepernick and Kevin Durant because Kevin Durant had said he's not going to the White House. That's why.
Showed lack of patriotism.
Losing to Donald Trump, I guess. That faction of the country who feel pissed off that Donald Trump is in office. That's why he refers to him as a
soul loser.
What was
Tom Brady every time it was time to visit Obama and he needed a doctor's
home? Question.
He wasn't a loser. Okay. That's fair.
Okay.
So then you have Jim Brown, who we admire. I love Jim Brown. One of probably the greatest NFL player to ever play the game. Is that fair to say? This week said and spoke on Colin Kaepernick. I'm going to play his comments. You guys give me your thoughts on his point of view.
Jim, break down from your perspective. I think you have a very unique perspective on this, the Colin Kaepernick situation. Whether or not you think he should be playing, what this says about the state of the NFL today, views.
Well, you know, Colin has to make up his mind whether he's truly an activist or whether he's a football player. If you try to be both...
I'm going to pause it there. Let's not forget the era in which Jim Brown played NFL football. The mid-60s, correct? What was going on in the 60s?
Some movement about civil rights.
Yeah, civils and shit. Wasn't he part of a protest with other athletes?
Kareem Abdul.
Absolutely.
Not you, OJ. But some other guys,
other guys, yes. But he was able to be an athlete and an activist at the same time, correct?
Okay, I'm just a serious activist.
I'm just asking.
Football is commercial. You have owners. You have fans. And you want to honor that if you're making that kind of money. If you have a cause... I think you should organize it, present it in a manner where it's not only you standing, sitting on one knee, but a lot of people that is going to get behind each other and do something about it.
Now that I can get with.
Okay. I'll ask you one question. Who is calling on to follow what he's talking about? So many of us have always done it, and we're here to help anyone that wants to do it. But I would advise a young man, if you're a football player, play football. You're going to be a real activist. Use your money. Use your notoriety. I didn't want to make it this long.
Which he has done, though.
He sure has.
He has done. Mind you, he's donated money, not guaranteed a job.
A lot of money.
A lot of money at that.
My question is, does Jim feel like Colin is not reaching out to the activists of yesterday? Is that his issue?
Because
I feel like that he's basically saying, like, you're not reaching out to the channels you should be to get to where you need to be. So I don't think that I would put him
on
that
still
train.
Let's
hear the whole thing.
It
does have meaning to me, and I think that I want to be in his corner, and I do thank God bless him, but that's not my leadership.
You don't believe that in today's NFL you could be both activist and football player?
I think we're always an activist and a football player, but I think you have to understand there's intelligence that's involved. Okay? I can't be two things at once that contradict each other. If I sign for money, then these people I sign with, they have rules and regulations.
Really, Jim Brown? We'll get to that later.
Give it a real deal. I'm an American. I don't desecrate my flag.
That's where he loses me.
And my national anthem.
Come on, Jim.
How did Colin Kaepernick desecrate the flag?
Did he burn it?
No.
Step on it?
No.
Did he spit on it?
No.
It's a peaceful protest.
Hold on.
As far as the anthem. I'm not
going to do anything against the flag and the national anthem. Mm. I'm going to work within those situations. But this is my country, and I'll work out the problems, but I'll do it in an intelligent manner. Mm.
So I think he's basically saying that all is well when you come back to this, but the fact that he did it on television, the fact that it was a game and the people that are paying you money put you on that television, you should.
So the fact that he gets paid money, he's not allowed to.
He could have articulated.
Where was he supposed to do it? In his own room and close the shades so no one sees it?
I agree with you. I totally agree with you. He could have articulated a little better.
Jim has totally lost me.
I told you.
He totally lost me.
But here's the thing. So he mentioned something about you can't do two things that contradict themselves.
But he did.
It's so funny that he says that.
Correct.
This is Jim Brown back in the 60s who fought the power for civil rights. But you can't also fight women in your home as well. Mm. All right.
Some exclusive investigating this morning.
No, it was a,
by
it,
Preach.
This is well known. Like okay. this is
because I didn't notice.
Well, yeah, he's been out there wilding. He's been doing this since the 60s.
Let's read some of Jim Brown's.
I'm not gonna
highlights.
Read it all because this
because I mean, we'll be here all day.
Here's the funny thing, and I'll mention it afterwards. So in 1965, a jury finds Brown not guilty of assault and battery against an 18-year-old Brenda Ayers after an incident in a hotel room. Mm. Just to preface, like, he's been known to have domestic disputes. Like, he's been known to hit women.
That's now, this is the 60s you're in.
Yes, this is the 60s. All right, so let me skip a few.
Skip a decade or two. What happened in the 80s?
We're still going to stay in the 60s. 1968, Brown is charged with assault with intent to commit murder after model Eva Bond is found beneath the balcony of Brown's second floor apartment.
Beneath the balcony.
Yeah, I guess she was hiding. The charge is later dismissed after Bond refuses to name him as the assailant.
Let me stop you 1 second. Mm-hmm. How dangerous is a situation where you hide on a second floor balcony?
Right.
Continue.
Exactly. Let me just skip a few. All right, let's get to the 80s. Okay, 1985, Brown is charged with raping and assaulting a 33-year-old woman.
At a Culture Club concert.
In his home.
Yes.
The judge later dismisses the charges based on inconsistent testimony. Right. Okay, fair enough. 1986, Brown is arrested for assaulting live-in girlfriend Deborah Clark. The charges are later dropped. Mm.
So far, you've read 5, correct?
We're still 1985.
If this were video footage, you see the hair getting shorter and shorter.
Right. 1999, June
15th. Y2K, ladies and gentlemen.
Yes, following a domestic disturbance with his wife, Jim Brown is arrested and charged with making terrorist threats towards his wife.
Terrorist threats, you say?
Yes. Mm. And there's also a 911 call.
But he doesn't desecrate the flag.
Didn't desecrate
the flag. And he doesn't do any of this bullshit during the game.
No. That's the most important part. Yes. September 10th, 1999. A jury finds Brown guilty of vandalism for smashing his wife's car with a shovel during the June incident. He's later fined $1,800 and sentenced to 3 years probation.
So where's this anger against white supremacy?
I don't know. January 5th, 2000. So it just turned 2000.
It's getting in Cinema Millennium now.
Yeah, but I mean, this is January 5th.
For those of you who weren't impressed with his 60s work.
Brown is sentenced to 6 months in jail for refusing the court order counseling and community service handed down in 1995. He serves almost 4 months in county jail in 2002. Wow. So my question is, you just told somebody you can't do two things that contradict themselves. Mm. Yet you fought for civil rights, which is commended.
Word.
But then you also beat women.
OJ just heard this list and was like, damn.
You fought for civil rights and fought the women you were dating.
Exactly. But apparently you can't do both.
Yo, let me read some of these comments. Robert Jones says he has CTE. I'm convinced. The controversial Antoine Fisher.
Okay.
Inside joke there. Jim is a paid employee within the NFL. Thomas says slight difference. He didn't protest on the job.
Mm. That's what he's saying. Yeah, well, we get that.
So wait a minute. So we're excusing, or we should just negate the fact that he beat his wife.
Yes.
Multiple women.
Exclude that.
Girlfriend.
That doesn't offend you.
But shovels people hiding in the balcony.
Right. But the fact that somebody kneeled during the national anthem, that's where you cross the line.
So mm-hmm. You have 30 years of abuse, right? About 30 years, yeah. Right? 60 something.
Oh, don't show change. And this 40, is 40, 40 plus.
And by the way, this is what we know about. This exactly. Is what he's been arrested.
We don't know
for.
If he hitting Sister Esther now.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
Yes.
Right. With his cane.
Exactly. You bitch. Turn that Colin Kaepernick off right now.
So I ask you.
Yes.
Knowing what we know, I'm not doing it because I still gotta respect the man for what he's done.
Man, I'm doing it.
He's brought gangs together and trying to,
sure.
You know, resolve a situation in the hood in multiple places. He wasn't a front line. This is why it's so confusing, because he was the same man sitting there in that press conference with all those other black athletes fighting the oppression.
I think someone's stirring a tea in front of him. I think he's in a sunken place, B. I think he's gone.
Putting him in a coon train?
I got to.
Yeah.
You're putting him Jim Brown.
I got to, B.
What is the explanation of why you're putting Jim Brown in the coon train?
First of all, I don't got to explain shit to you.
Okay.
Secondly, you just gave all reasons why just now. Okay? Bottom line, look at how he's acting.
Right.
Look at how he's acting. So he's trying to negate his work, his wonderful work. I'm not talking about his extra marital affairs here.
Right.
But his wonderful work that he's done during the 60s and 70s. Look at how he's acting now. Mm-hmm. Now I get it. He wants to see the man keep his job, and he's trying to put him on the game as to how to do that.
Right,
or whatever.
Right.
But you're still, you're not fighting against what you're supposed to fight for, which is white supremacy.
Right.
Not against women.
Right. A lot of people have brought up the fact that it wasn't just the protest against the national anthem. It's also where I believe he wore socks with pigs on it.
Okay.
Referring with police.
Which is offensive.
Absolutely.
Get that. But if you want to deal with that being offensive, bring up that lost verse of the national anthem, which speaks about slavery and all its slaves.
Right.
But because you guys don't sing that anymore, you forget who that song was written by and what it's about.
Right. Voice, are you putting Jim Brown, number 32, in the coon train?
I would have to.
Yeah,
the reason why also, aside from what you mentioned, the inconsistencies and the fact that he's showing that he's conforming now.
He's also how old? He's also in his 70s.
But that's when you're supposed to talk
your
shit.
Exactly. You don't conform at 70. You don't conform at 70.
You're supposed to not give a damn anymore.
You know old black grandparents say whatever.
Are the rudest people alive. You know this.
They say whatever they want, boy.
Old people, period. Old people are nasty people.
No filter.
They are.
Now we're old shaming.
Oh, seriously. If you're over 70, you're a dick. Fight me. It is what it is. Chances are 9 out of 10 of you are assholes. It is what it is.
Now we're age shaming right now.
Oh, so be it.
Crystal, you are putting Jim Brown on the coon train. Are you?
I'll take Maxwell off if you do.
Oh, no, come on.
You can't do that.
No,
man.
Come on.
A little bargaining.
You promise?
Of course.
No.
Crystal, is Jim Brown in the coon train?
Come on, Crystal. Come on.
Can't put him in the coon train.
What? I can't put him either, man.
I can't put him in the coon train.
Well, you know who breaks our tie.
Oh, man.
Our lovable engineer,
Boris.
We also
have two other people here, too.
Yeah. Boris gives the wrong answer. I'm going to the other two people.
All right. So, Crystal says no. I say no.
I can't do it.
All right. So, we're 2-2.
2-2.
Mr. Boris. Your job depends on this.
He's also a part of the younger generation, Trump. So he might not understand the impact that Jim Brown has had.
Oh, he's offended by it.
Okay, my fault. You know what?
You saw through his glasses. Yeah, exactly.
Ageism. I'm sorry. I'm an ageist. I'm sorry.
Nah, you
can
go.
Oh. Thank you, Boris.
And they vote.
3-2.
And you vote.
3-2. And Preach's sister, who is in the building.
You said you're too young?
I'm too young to appreciate the old, what he did.
Well, so it's official.
Official.
You and Adam.
Our studio audience here as well.
Boris, cue up the music, man.
I hate my own people. White supremacy ain't bad after all.
Yes. But you know what? He's not in. I can't put him in the same cart as, let's say, Jason Whitlock.
Nah,
you gotta give him more than that.
Of course not.
It's the
same. He's on the quiet train.
Course, yeah,
yeah.
You
know, he's in the quiet car.
He's in a quiet car.
He's in the quiet car.
Okay, Acela.
Yeah.
Yeah. Fair enough. Business class.
I can't put him on the same cart or put him near the same seat as Jason Whitlock or George Foreman or any of those.
Nah, yeah, that's fair. That's fair.
Photographers that we can't do. Put him in the same.
That's fair.
He needs his own cart because you know what? Like, let's just say when it's time to get off, he'll be the first
Thomas
to get off.
Thomas says BS, he's not on that train. Hey. Y'all feel a way about it, y'all write your congressman. He's on our train and that's that.
No, well they can majority
rules.
They can share their opinions.
Majority rules.
I just say that he'd be the first to get
like DeAndre says cargo area.
You can't put him in the cargo area. He can't.
Like he's some monkey.
He's not a dog.
Disrespectful. That's disrespectful.
Put him in the cargo area.
That is
man.
Disrespectful.
Like I said,
he's on a bus of that domestic violence train. Or what?
Yeah, no.
What about that?
Listen, if it was a domestic violence train, he would be the driver.
I just don't understand.
I honestly feel like there's no
that I agree to.
Like there's no.
I got 40 years in the game of that.
And you know what's
right,
crazy?
Exactly.
Hilarious because we were mentioning this during our pre-show prep. And so I'm ringing off the dates, saying the 60s. And Bino's like, all right, well, maybe it was the 60s. Once I said 1990, you're like, oh, damn.
Yeah, it's pretty bad.
Like, 99,
you go from Rolling Stones to New Kids on the Block on the radio, you still doing the same shit.
Right.
That's a career.
Exactly. Right. No carpal tunnel.
Like, that's what you do.
Tennis elbow.
I just don't understand how we're giving a pass. How so many people are willing to give a pass.
But I mean, we're already giving him a pass by saying, well, you know what? Even though he did this, he was still major in civil rights. Like, no, you're over there beating the women that you're supposed to be protecting.
You can't call.
You're fighting for rights and you're beating them at the same time. How is that possible?
You can't call black women queens and you're beating
ass.
And then
you beat them. And they're hiding under her belt.
And they want to talk like Shazai afterwards. My ebony queen. Your smooth coconut oil skin that I slapped. I mean, like, cut it out.
You can't
cut it out, B.
Because he mentioned himself, you can't play two sides and be hypocritical or contradict yourself.
Which was a controversy.
Hold on, let me read some of these comments. So Antoine Fisher, the controversial Antoine Fisher, he knows what I'm talking about. Jim does make a point whether he knows it or not. Plenty of owners within the NFL don't really care about social injustice. Plenty, if not all owners, are white males. I believe you can't be an activist in playing a football. Players' checks come from master. Well, see, that's what we were talking about a week or so ago.
Of course.
Capitalism takes away from a lot of shit.
Right.
And activism in particular. Right. We all want to be activists. My boss told me some shit today. I mean, the other day, yo. I raised the fist and I had to put it back down. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah.
At the end of the day, those light bills don't pay themselves. You understand what I'm saying? So, you got to come to a conclusion here. But if he's able to do it.
Right.
And
I just don't.
Able to live
I mean,
the consequences.
I agree with you in saying that. Look, I understand people have bills to pay, but there's also a idea of having like self worth or having an integrity within yourself and
but
saying
that's,
like
that's a bigger problem because we don't run shit.
We need to start doing it though.
Need to start.
And the blacks that do have power,
mm-hmm.
like that evil boss of mine I was talking about, they don't do anything for no one else underneath them.
Right.
You know? But that's a lot of the problem. Once you get somewhere, you should be pulling other people up with you. They don't do it. It's a crab in a barrel. Like, I'm up here.
Exactly.
You can stay down here.
Exactly.
And that's the problem.
You don't want to share
you
the
can
secret.
Still do it.
Right. There's so many black players in the NFL. They could have bought a team a long time ago with that money. They could have done a lot of things that they have not been doing, and that's why people treat us the way they treat us. Because we get something, and I'm talking about black people as a whole. People like, not me, but as a whole, we don't take care of what we're supposed to take care of and put money back into
own it. That is a great, you know what?
So then we can then own it. Like,
out of
the
all
problem.
The praying and slaying you've done on that mic. That was one of the greatest things you've said.
Hey, well, hey, look at you here.
What is how many NFL players are there in the league? There's 53. It's 53 players
people
on the
on
roster,
each roster,
but not all of them. But I'd say they're like 80%, 80 or 70%. Let's say you put every one of them put like $1 million into owning one team. They could own a team, but I'm pretty sure they'd find a way to. Say conflict of interest or something like that.
I mean, whatever it is, still, if we pull it together and people know that we are serious about what we're talking about, they start treating you different because now you have the money. Money is the root of everything. You have it. Now they talk to you a little differently.
Truth be told, that's the one difference between us and Jews.
Yes.
They talk to you different.
They got money. These supremacists, you look at them. After they name us, they talk about the Jews second. They don't love the Jews either.
They're not
watching Seinfeld.
But you know what they did? Right. But they pull their stuff together. And I've never seen, I've worked in the Jewish world for a long time. If someone needed a job, they wouldn't even care. Like, I don't trust that person. No, you need a recommendation. They barely knew them and gave them a recommendation.
That's real.
Do you need help with something? They said, listen, I don't care who it is. You're Jewish. I'm going to help you. Black people be like, listen, I got one bad so-and-so from a black owner. I'm not doing it no more. That's the problem. You can't let one person affect everyone else.
What?
Like,
if you're in a office place or whatever, corporation,
mm-hmm.
Another black person see another black person. They turn to that face. You see that other affirmative action dude?
Right.
Like, you don't even want to know.
Right.
You try to shake their hand a soul brother way. They want to shake your hand a regular way. They want to just fit in and get through their day. They're not helping anyone and not putting anyone else on. And that's what this is about.
Nobody likes to
horrible.
Rock the boat. That's the problem, too.
I don't think it's about rocking the boat. I think it's about supporting one another.
But in order to do that, though, think about it.
Listen, we might be opening a different avenue when I ask this question, but is there a difference? Because I feel like there is, but I feel like there's a difference when you're talking about African Americans and then West Indian or Caribbean.
I totally Caribbean agree with you, but
Caribbean African Americans.
I agree with what you're saying, but I also feel like as a whole, like West Indian people be like, I don't, dumb Americans, they act different. We are all black. We all came from one place and got shipped over here. Mm-hmm. That we could do so much more, again, if we pulled our money and spent it back in the black community. People start talking to you differently. Oh, you know what? This is, I myself, like, I try at least 2 or 3 times a month to buy from a black business. I don't care how bad that business is. I would rather email you. I would rather say to you, listen, I had a horrible experience with your company, but as a black woman to another black woman, this is what you do to make it better. I'm not going to say I'm never buying black again. You never heard a white person say, I'm never buying white again ever in my life. Because I had it's a bad experience with one company. Like, black people need to change the way they think because that's why we're being held back.
Shout out to Crossover Negroes. I said the same thing.
I don't shop at Haitian restaurants. I had a terrible experience at a Haitian restaurant.
You never shop there again.
Yo, Antoine says, but they teach us to hate ourselves and divide and conquer.
That's fact.
Bakari says, what about how Africans don't like African Americans? Bakari, I'm going to answer that for you. Being African and African American myself, so I see it on both sides.
Right.
It happens on both sides of the spectrum. The Africans are, they come here and they feel that the African Americans here don't take advantage of the opportunities that mm-hmm. they've been born into. Mm-hmm. Because everyone comes here from all over the world for an opportunity.
Right.
Like those Africans you see selling bootleg shit on the street,
right.
they're better off here than where they're from.
Of course.
You understand what I'm saying? So like they look at the Africans here who just, you know, dab and listen to the bad music all day, whatever the fuck y'all do. You understand what I'm saying? Like they look at them like, what are y'all doing with your opportunity here? And of course, the African Americans here look at the Africans like, oh, y'all think y'all better, or the Caribbeans the same way.
Right.
It's just what it is. So,
right. All right, let's take a quick break. When we come back, we got a lot to talk about. Sunday morning breakfast. We'll be right back.
I wasn't prepared to be a caregiver to mom, but a little over a year ago, we realized she couldn't take care of herself without our help. And, well, how could I not be there for her? I had no idea how hard it would be and just what I would need to know. Things I never thought of, like how to improve her mood and, even for me, ways to stay positive. Luckily, I found the Caregiving Resource Center from AARP. It had articles about the basics that got me started, but also information about the hurdles I was facing in this new role. I could even connect with experts and hear from others who had been in my place. I know this road we're on isn't an easy one, but I'm really happy to have the extra help for her and for me. Caregiving Resource Center at aarp.org/caregiving. Articles, tips, and tools to help you both care for your loved one and care for yourself. This message is brought to you by AARP and the Ad Council.
What's good? This is Bino Tarantino. You are now listening to Sunday Morning Breakfast only on Soundcast.fm.
Keyboard Cat, Hamilton the Pug, and Toast Meets World. These are some of the internet's most beloved pets. With millions of YouTube views, shares, Instagram likes, followers, and fans across the globe. But what do all these amazing pets have in common? Their stories started in a shelter. Start your story. Adopt a dog or cat today. Visit theshelterpetproject.org to find a shelter or adoptable pets near you. Training that pet to play the keyboard? Well, that's entirely up to you. Visit theshelterpetproject.org and hear more about Hamilton the Pug, Toast, and Keyboard Cat's amazing adoption stories. Start a story. Adopt a shelter or rescue pet today. Your perfect pet is just a click away at theshelterpetproject.org. A public service announcement brought to you by Maddie's Fund, the Humane Society of the United States, and the Ad Council.
Hey, Dr. Phil here. I help people solve difficult and trying personal problems every day on my TV show, but there's one problem that's just got me stumped. Childhood hunger. Nearly 16 million children in America struggle with it. That's 1 in 5 kids who may not know where their next meal is coming from, despite the fact that there's more than enough healthy, nutritious food out there to feed them all. Now, I don't know about you, but that is unacceptable to me. Luckily, the Feeding America network of good people is out there collecting surplus food and giving hope to hungry children and their families at local food banks all across the country. But let's face it, they can't do it without your help. Join me in supporting Feeding America and your local food bank at feedingamerica.org.
Brought to you by Feeding America and the Ad Council.
Together, we can solve hunger. Together, we're feeding America.
All right, Sunday morning breakfast. Call us at 516-900-2278. We have a few viral videos we want to dissect real quick. But quick news, Ric Flair has been released from the hospital, man. I know a lot of people, a lot of wrestling fans.
Did you
fans.
See that video of him?
Yeah, man. I think, do I have it here?
He can barely be like, ooh.
Oh man,
I feel bad. I saw it last night.
Wow. Leave him alone, man. He's well, how old is he?
Still.
Here's a worldwide, the nature boy. Ooh, back up and running.
Oh, yeah, that was bad.
See,
I want to tell all my fans out there for all the love, support, and I was in the very, 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 very near future.
Yes, yeah, it's not the same.
It's not that. Look at
that. Let me hear that. Let me hear that again.
Worldwide. The nature boy.
Oh, yeah.
See, I thought I was joking.
That's terrible. And when you see an owl?
I don't know. That was pretty bad.
Like, us growing up with Ric Flair, you know what that woo meant.
Yes.
Oh, my God. That was pretty
bad. Well, good for him that he beat the surgery or whatever.
Yeah, I'm glad he's back, man. There was this clip out with Caitlyn Jenner. I guess she was leaving an event. And it's something that we've been saying a couple times on this show, referring to her position in the trans community and the LGBT community, where there's been people who kind of don't look at her as a representative of them. Like, they just basically see it as just another publicity stunt. Mm-hmm. And so somebody decided to confront her about it. Here's this video with, I guess there's a bunch of protesters, but there's one specific woman really good, which has the bullhorn all loud and volume at max. Like, she's really going
in. She must be heard, yes.
And this is how the exchange went. I love Inside Edition.
Caitlyn Jenner under attack.
You are an insult to trans people. You are an insult to women. You have no right to represent us.
Jenner was heckled as she left a charity event.
Like, right all in the face?
Where she shared her experience as a transgender woman.
We have been assaulted by police. We have been violated. We have been violated by the system.
The former Olympian took time to speak with one protester who said she was having trouble finding a job.
Wait a minute, pause it. Wait a minute.
I'm not gonna hire your black ass, but good luck and Godspeed.
So wait, the premise of your protest, forget other trans women in the trans community. You were looking for a job, you were pissed off that you don't have a job?
So you went with the bullhorn to go protest. Confront Caitlyn.
To read your resume out loud for everyone in the crowd.
Where you get some money from.
September 2010 to present. Currently working at Walmart. That you kind of lose everything once.
Cal's correcting you. Says he, preach.
Oh, he. Thank you. I'm so sorry. Wait. No. Who's being referred to as he?
Caitlyn, I believe.
No, Caitlyn's a she.
She's a she now.
You have to respect that she's a she, Caitlyn. You hear that, Carol? Yes. Get on board, Carol. Ugh.
I think Carol's going to be offended you called her Caitlyn.
Who'd have it we offended today? Let's go ahead and see the rest of the clip.
But I have a cool question before we start the rest of the clip. Crip. If he...
Crip. Yeah, it's just...
Yeah.
If she...
Who are we referring to?
Caitlyn. Okay. If she just became a woman and she didn't want to be the face of anything, I think people would still think that she was representing them because she's famous.
I don't think so.
You don't think so?
I don't think so. I think if she just lived her life and she wasn't on TV,
I think
if she wasn't on the cover of a magazine and all that shit, that was weirdly what did.
Yeah, you're right.
It wasn't for all that. If it was just, look, I just want to wear heels and shit in private. Yeah. That's my business. That's one thing. Because that's all she does.
Right.
That's all this is about. This isn't about I'm a representative of the transgender community and all that. This is, I see heels, I want to put my big feet in them, and I want to wear dresses, and that's it. That's what it is. Because the political views haven't changed. They're not any more accepting than they were in the first place.
Not.
I mean, it just is what it is.
And she still decides to wear a Make America Great hat,
even after
he banned transgender people from joining the military. So, I mean, I think a lot of it had to do with what Bino mentioned, the cover, the magazine cover. We all remember that. And then it was the reality show after that. Like, she had her own series.
Call Me Caitlyn.
Yeah. And it was like, no, how about you just do some events without, don't bring the cameras around. Don't have the publicity. Even though she would have had the press there, just do these events, meet with transgender people and talk about their struggle and actually be in the forefront of it as opposed to making a series about it.
Mm-hmm.
But
Antoine says, bro, you can change the outside appearance to the max. On the inside, you're still a 70-something-year-old man on the inside. You can't change your mind. You are a white privileged man in the head.
All right, let's see what's the clip.
I 100% agree.
We have been violated by the system.
She's like, where the hell is this damn truck? Yeah. Now, do I get a job or what? Do I do well in this interview or no? So, I mean, I don't know what you guys feel about this whole Caitlyn thing. I mean, look, I don't think she's been in the forefront.
That is all publicity. That's basically what it
is. It's bullshit. Like, I mean, it is what it is. And this is no disrespect to those who truly identify with another gender and all that. That's right. Your business. But again, that's your business. Don't try to use it for something that it's not.
Right.
Period.
I mean, documenting the whole change in the Diane Sawyer interview. And
Caitlyn's worth has what, tripled since this whole thing?
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, and you have to ask yourself, what's more to Caitlyn? What's worth more? Being in the forefront of this movement or gaining more money from you changing your body?
Clearly gaining more money. Yeah. It is what it is.
Crystal said money is the root of everything, right?
Right, and then there's this other video. This is crazy. Pull up the Miami video. So apparently there was a confrontation in a hotel lobby in our beautiful state of Florida.
White Bay.
Yes.
White Bay.
Yes.
Yes.
So I'm trying to read the story. Okay, so apparently the older woman in the teal dress was saying some racist things to...
She saw a nice interracial relationship.
Yes, saying a few things. Why do people still feel like they can make comments? Like, if you see an interracial couple, that's a lot of balls to say, ugh.
And they know what's going to happen afterwards.
Guy. She was talking about a Haitian guy.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. I think you see him. But, you know, his white bae.
Correct.
And then, listen.
His Ivory Queen.
Ivory Queen. Yes. His milk of magnesia.
Correct.
Decided to defend him. Respect his honor.
You see the shoes coming off, right?
Yeah. Wait. Before you play. Now, that's when you know it's serious.
Correct.
As we have two women in here.
When
you take your shoes off
you
and the earrings
balance.
And the earrings come off.
Oh yeah, definitely. You don't want anybody pulling your loops.
She wasn't, you know, able to take the earrings off.
So wait, you would take your shoe off? You take your shoe off? Yeah. Oh, you. So you take your time.
You warn them.
You would
right.
warn them. I'm about to beat your ass.
What if you got Air Jordans on? That's what I know.
Especially if you got J's. What? I ain't getting stepped on for...
I understand heels. If you have heels or whatever, yeah, you got to take them off. You want to make sure it's obviously balanced.
If you got shoes worth a damn on, they come off.
They come off. All right, so let's play this video. This is when you know it's about to go down. Oh.
Oh.
I'm taking my shit off so that if she puts her hands on me, I can't.
Oh, now pause it there. Now, when she went in the woman's face, you're asking for it.
Correct. Correct.
Can that be deemed self-defense, though?
Absolutely.
No. I mean, you mean what self-defense? The one sitting down taking off her shoes?
Yes.
Yes, absolutely.
Wait, no. All she did was go on a person's face.
No,
I'm not
you. She put
no,
her
she no, touched
by law,
her.
You
she
probably had to be touched first.
No,
she
was touched her.
I think you have to, all right.
She was touched.
All right, let's watch the rest of it.
Watch. Watch.
She touched her.
She touched her.
Oh. There it is.
There it is. All right, you can play it. It gets...
Boom.
It gets, boom. It gets coyote
boom.
Ugly.
Boom.
It is coyote
boom.
Ugly on this. Oh,
boom.
My Lord.
Boom.
Oh.
Boom.
Oh.
Ronda Rousey on that.
I'm not going to lie.
Look at the Haitian man.
Oh. I'm waiting.
Baby, stop.
Baby, please stop, baby. And then she says... I don't know if any of you guys can tell. I don't know if the clip goes that far. She then tells security that she's pregnant.
Yeah.
The one in the teal suit.
Was she pregnant before she got ass?
Exactly.
I don't know. Or maybe the ass woman was so much.
To the pregnancy?
She put the pregnancy back.
She got shoe for that lady.
Okay. No, I'm sorry. You asked for that.
Absolutely.
Now,
pregnant or not, I'm sorry.
So we all agree that she asked for it, yes?
Yes, absolutely.
So now, in white girl coolness history,
yes.
Where is she? Because I say she's under Topanga. Topanga being top.
Nah, she's, I
say she's right under Topanga. She's not on Topanga's level yet.
Yes,
no,
she is.
She's over Topanga.
Yeah, she is. She's over Topanga.
To you, she's over Topanga.
She's over Topanga.
Yes, Topanga dealt with that damn Corey.
Topanga is a character.
This is
somebody I can get an autograph from and be admired.
Will you remember her a week or two from now?
Yes, I will. White Bay.
Okay, how about for years from now?
Topanga's
not remembered.
I'm going to get a gold chain with her figure on it.
You know, you got to put her in the background.
I will not. You touch me again?
You have to commend
that. Wow, really?
Yeah, defending absolutely. Racism.
No, I respect it.
Baby,
she gets the background picture, baby.
I think y'all feeling it because the dude was Haitian.
Yes.
I think that's what this shit's about, B. The dude's Haitian and y'all feeling
that.
It.
I won't.
You admit,
I won't
you admit the bias?
I won't deny it.
Okay.
I mean, mind you, she look at the sweatshirt he is wearing. I mean, come on. Wait, let's play the whole thing again because this... I mean, we both know it's
that
about
that lady don't got no bra on.
Shaped like an egg at that.
It looks like the penguin.
Some nerve.
With one of your shoes...
Oh, whoa. I didn't hear that. Wait, pause.
Don't talk?
Yeah.
Whoa. This is Florida.
She said, "I'm going to
shoot you."
I thought only the rappers speak this way. I'm surprised.
Wait a minute. After hearing that, that doesn't put her over Topanga after that?
Seriously, no.
What? Topanga was great. Don't get me wrong.
Topanga's white baby. I'm sorry.
All right.
She's over Kelly Kapowski. I'll give you that.
I've been over Kelly Kapowski. Go ahead. Y'all. Ever since what she did to Zach, get out of here.
That's true. She was.
Come on, man. You don't do Zach like that with Jeff.
They married anyway. Calm down.
No, but she, come on, Jeff.
Boy, she's walking like that.
Watch her.
Telling her what room she's in.
That was better than the Mayweather fight.
I'm here for it.
Yeah, she was.
But wait, the person with the video camera never moved.
But look at the guy next to her. Like, he's like, oh, man, I'm
gonna let that rock.
Baby. Baby. Stop it, baby.
And I don't even think she got her shoes fully off, did she?
No, I don't think so.
One shoe still on.
She ain't need to.
Nah, see, don't approach after, like, no. She's Hall of Fame status.
Look, and her hair's still perfectly done. Like, she's all right.
I ain't gonna lie, that kind of turned me on. That was kind of amazing to watch.
Should I leave the room?
This was kind of amazing to watch.
What's her name?
And she's still ready for that action.
Okay.
So I know we have the Coon train, but we need like a Hall of Fame type of status, and I think she gets there, without a doubt. Yeah, S&B Hall of Fame. Or,
I think being over here hating a little bit because we not.
She got to be the background.
Never associate me with that word, but yeah, she's cool. Nah, she's cool. I'm giving her props. Just all this Topanga talk got me a little angry, but nah, she wins. She wins definitely.
Oh,
wins.
And so the woman actually released a statement. Sure, her name is Colleen Dagg.
Oh, I follow her. The woman, Instagram.
I do too.
Really?
So you follow? Yes.
But do you follow Topanga?
Yes, I do. Thank you.
Okay. Wait. Just making sure. You follow her. She's not getting the background pick.
First of all, who I follow is none of your damn business. Like this. What's with the questions?
Right. So she says this is a young country built on racism. Black people have been disenfranchised for over 250 years. See, that's what I'm talking about. This is what Jim Brown should have been saying. The faster white people accept and validate the truth, the closer we'll come to a place of peace and understanding. Fighting racism is dependent upon using my white privilege for the right reasons and throwing them hands. They were two examples. Thank you. Yes, go ahead. There were two examples of white privilege in the video. The woman in the blue dress tried to use her white privilege on me. The fact that I'm white too must have slipped her mind. If you see it, say something. If you see it, say something.
Do something.
It's really that simple. Disclaimer, some people can't handle the truth. Stay ready. Mm. Stay woke.
Stay woke.
So Antoine says. Antoine says, I love White Fighter Bay, but the whale teal lady was eating them punches. Controversial. Twan out. He's stupid. Ricardo says she's a good follow on Twitter as well.
Mm-hmm. I think I have to follow her.
Trini Mon, you joined us.
What's Trini Mon talking about?
Trini Mon just joined.
Oh, man.
She has to go in the Hall of Fame, man. That's
she got to go in the Hall of Fame with
Trini Mon. You didn't tell your opinion. Now, this is a Haitian man's woman.
Yes.
Defending his honor.
Yes.
Now, he was nowhere to be seen except for just holding him back.
Sure he was out the picture.
If you notice, both black guys just kind of sat back like,
hell yeah.
That's what you're supposed to do during a chick fight.
The other, Why did you get so emotional?
Because, the thought of me getting involved in females fighting, especially, are you crazy?
So if Sweet Mama was throwing hands, you wouldn't try to pull her back?
Sweet Mama ain't got to throw hands if I'm there. That's first and foremost. That's my point.
Hold on. Period. If there was a female to female.
I don't give a shit. Nobody touching Sweet Mama around me, period. So if her man got to pay, he'll pay. That's that. Like, it is what it is.
Brown?
Ask her. We've been in our little altercations before. I made it clear. Whoever touched Sweet Mama, it's your ass. You get to see your makers. Such is life. Wow. So
okay, brother. I ain't going to touch that one.
I'm sorry, is there a problem?
I'm just going to look that way. I'm just letting him talk.
Sweet Mama ain't got to touch anybody. It is what it is.
I'm doing the Elvin right now, Crystal.
You in the street with the hammer, your big ass.
he's about 7'5".
Okay, exactly.
Nobody's even looking at me when he's around. So
exactly.
I'm not a fair,
exactly
yeah,
my point.
Yeah,
so
yeah,
like no.
So okay, if Miss Corinne was involved in a situation that's similar,
that's not happening.
So
that's
you pull a.
I don't. And you know what? I want thoughts on this. Is it okay to assault another woman if your woman is being assaulted? Especially your wife.
I'm not saying assault another woman, but nobody's touching my girl, period.
That's all I'm saying.
Let's say somebody gets her from the back and you didn't know what's going on. Would you turn around and commence to whooping ass?
Yo, no comment.
Exactly.
No, 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 because then I try to run for president. Let's play his clip from Sunday Morning Breakfast in 2017.
By the way, there's been plenty of things said on this show.
But that won't be one of them. That won't be one of them. A lot of shit get me in trouble yet, but yeah, that's not going to be one of them.
I mean, a lot of comments have been said on this show that, we all aren't running for president.
Okay, so wait. Okay. So someone says something about T-Mobile in front of me and throws the phone across the room. How quick are you rolling up those
Sprint.
T-Mobile sleeves?
I love Sprint, jerk.
Verizon signal's way better. How quick are those sleeves?
I'll get my people on it.
You get your people on get it. People there's on a, it. There's a T-Mobile okay. gang.
Exactly. Get my people on it. I'll just watch for a while if it gets out of hand. I'll
you snapping their fingers.
T-Mobile.
Yo,
T-Mobile.
And Sweet Mama, to be fair, Sweet Mama hold me down the same way.
Of course.
Just a few weeks ago, there was some white woman who tried to pull some shit with me on a Whole Foods line.
Okay.
They got these bad.
You
got
Whole
right?
Foods?
Yeah. Well, the guy likes organic food like anyone else. I don't understand.
Shout out to Amazon.
Organic chicken?
The one on Bryant Park, right? The one on 42nd Street. They have what kind of bathrooms? Co-ed bathrooms, right. Basically. I guess it has to do with this whole cake shit. Anyway.
Right.
So I'm standing in line.
That's to do with the whole cake.
I'm online, right? Yeah. I'm online, and a dude is in front of me, and he dips. He's like, oh, no, I'm not in line. He dips. So I move up.
Okay.
About 30 seconds later, I get the tap on my back. You skipped me. Turn around and say, how the hell did I skip you? So we're arguing, and she goes, so I'm like, yo, bitch, I didn't skip you. Get the fuck out of here. So now it gets personal and ugly.
Right.
And she tries to pull the female card.
Right.
Tell her straight. I said, I can pull the Emmett Till card. Bottom line is, you're not getting in front of me.
Right.
So Sweet Mama, unfortunately, is like outside, but she hears commotion.
Oh, wow.
So I come outside.
She said, oh, God, it's Bino again.
Of course, you're not getting shit where I go. So she comes out, oh, I wish I was in that line. And she's all, I'm like, yo, chill. I already embarrassed the woman. It's over with.
Oh, man.
Like, I had it to the point where I'm like, yo, bitch, you keep it up. I'm going to have the whole line skip me, and you really going to be embarrassed.
Now, that's petty.
Like, it is what it is. That's, you know what I mean? Like,
no. Shit. You behind her. Exactly. You come in front of me. Go ahead.
So I literally start asking, yo, you want to get in front of me? You want to get in front of me? And people are like, oh, I don't want anything to do with this, but good job. You understand what I'm saying? My point is, she going to hold me down the same way. That's what you do for your partner, period.
All I'm asking is, are you allowed to, so if somebody hits you, if a woman hits you,
he better lay them out.
So, all right, so if it's a bunch of women, so like if it's a bunch of women jumping you,
that's what I'm saying.
Yeah, if it's a bunch of women jumping you,
does he have the right to swing?
He better swing for his life.
But what happens to the hole? You can't. You're not supposed to hit women.
Let me tell you something. There's a lot of what I feel like is if you're with your woman, that's your queen. Protect your queen. At any first of all, they should know better. You walking with a man, there should be no reason why a woman tries to jump you. If that's the case, turn around. Listen, you see, I don't see gender. I don't see anything. Because God forbid that happened to him, I would be on somebody's back.
You step in the ring, you're supposed to fight.
Yeah.
Period.
It's true.
You want to talk, let's keep it at the press conference. Period.
Somebody, let's say you and Corinne are walking. Somebody pulls her here. You're going to turn around and be like, no, you're a woman, so I can't really.
I understand.
Take her head off her.
I have no problem throwing the hands at a woman if that's the case.
If it's life or death, and if your girl or whoever you with.
Yeah, absolutely.
Please. Mm. Easily. And we'll sleep well that night.
Yeah.
Well,
yeah. Right.
What? Like them glorious. Damn,
right.
Them damn commercials, them NyQuil commercials.
Yeah, right.
Okay.
Ooh. All right.
Oh,
Sunday
not
morning.
You?
You wouldn't. If
so, you'd fight for T-Mobile, but not. No.
You wouldn't fight for the mother of your child if somebody attacked her.
Oh, no, my child can handle it.
No, 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 no.
We're
not asking that question.
Why she could be fucking Chuck Norris? Bottom line is, she's not fighting alone. Period.
If she's losing,
so she's winning. You still wouldn't.
I wouldn't. Why am I going to insult the injury? She's already pounded that dude or whoever is out.
No, I'm talking about another woman hitting your woman.
Thank you, Antoine. Y'all subscribe to some strange rules. Right. Ain't no rules in fighting.
Right, right.
Rules are for the library.
Right.
She can handle it.
What we're saying is, let's say she gets sucker punched or she just gets jumped. Are you swinging your hands? Are you swinging some fists at other women to protect your woman?
No, I'll be like, babe, go handle it.
Well, you can't deal with Maya B.
Yeah, you can't.
Maya B says, if anybody hits me and the man does nothing, it's over.
Right.
You damn right.
She wouldn't even want me to. She wouldn't even want me to. She
wouldn't tell
me. She'd even want me to. She'd be like, I got it. She wouldn't even want me to.
I'm not. No.
She wouldn't even want me to.
Forget the Incredible Hulk status. I'm asking a simple question. She walks out of whatever restaurant, whatever supermarket. She gets jumped for whatever reason by a bunch of women. She doesn't see it coming. In the process of her getting jumped, you're not going to look at her and say, hey, go handle it.
See, that's a difference, though. If it's a bunch of women, it's not a fair fight.
It's not a difference. That's what we were just saying.
No, that's what I'm saying.
In circumstances like this, no.
Is she a Mighty Morphin Power Ranger?
I would like to claim her to be, yes. Lord. Absolutely.
Cut his mic.
She can handle it. She can handle it.
Let me tell you something. If I, God forbid, I was somewhere and I got jumped and he was like, babe, you can handle it. No, turn around and I want you to morph into the Hulk. And
she gives me the signal, be like, yo.
I want to see women flying. Boom,
because even if it's a dude and it's a bunch of dudes, sweet mama jumping on somebody back.
Right, exactly. Yeah.
Whatever damage she doing is
I'm a little different.
But she jumping on somebody back.
Listen, I'm a little different.
You are.
If she comes to me, she tells me, yo.
A lot different, possibly.
No. She comes to me, tells me, yo, all right, let's do this. We're in.
How in the process of her being jumped?
You can't speak for that.
She's going to say, wait.
I know how we roll.
Hey, babe, I got this.
You can't speak for that. We talked about it plenty of times and all that stuff. She basically said, if she can't handle it, she'll give me the signal. Go, get in, get involved.
What would make her talk about this plenty
Corinne,
of times?
Hold on,
y'all can't speak for that.
Corinne says
we already have an understanding.
Corinne says voice, zip it.
And make me. Look, here's the situation. If we already have an understanding, this is how she rolls. I respect it.
No, we're not.
Bottom line.
So she get pounded out and you're not going to do nothing because she told you she can handle it?
I just don't think it will get that far.
Man, I'm getting just angry just thinking about somebody. Right.
I don't think it will get that far.
I don't know any of my skillet.
Listen, my lady's a prideful woman. She's a prideful woman. She's on some, I don't need people to defend me if I can handle myself. That's basically
it.
Here's the thing. With this video, this was a straight one-on-one. Like, right. What our man did was the right thing. Because
he wasn't even there. He came back around the corner
But even if he was there, he assessed it. She said, all right, well, if she wants to throw them hands, let her throw them hands. And she held it down.
Absolutely.
She absolutely held it down. It wasn't like her man jumped in and got in sneaking punches or anything like that. He held her back after a while. Notice both men kind of backed up and let the ass kicking happen.
Right.
They were like, nah, she deserves this guy.
But now, if there's any other person who gets involved,
if that woman in teal was getting her ass kicked and her friend saw her.
The whistling and the Klan came through.
if that situation would occur, we'd hand it later. I'm not touching a woman.
My mother said enough voice. My mother got a comment on this.
I respect what everybody's saying, but I cannot put my hands on a female. That's it. We'll handle it later.
You're going to die a gentleman, bro.
I can't.
You're going to put that shit right on your tombstone.
Under any circumstance, I will never do it. We'll handle it later. That's how it feels.
I mean, if...
Let me read some of these comments.
But it's also like the anger in it, too. I don't know how you just say these. I'm not going to hit women.
Yo, DeAndre said, I don't even like the mother of my children, but... But if anyone touches her, they die.
I can't put my hand on her.
Listen, Antoine Fisher says voice is a wild ninja. Mm-hmm. If your shorty gets bopped in the face and can't give you the bat signal, then what? You waiting to jump in?
We take care of it later.
And if
you take care of it later?
Just
though?
I refuse to continue that part of the conversation, but we take care of it later. I'm not putting a hand on female.
What? In the Jim Brown?
We're not.
Are you gonna kick your ass? How you gonna lose that fight? Go in the balcony right now.
I can't do it. I can't do it.
What kind of?
I can't do it. I can't do it. I cannot put my hands on female.
I know, right?
No more.
Tag your question.
You know, it's your wild dude, you never cease to amaze me. I've been on the show for nine months now?
Yeah.
10 months? And you still, every show, you just say something that really takes my breath away.
That's a good thing, hopefully.
No, it's not.
I cannot.
It's not.
So me telling you that I can't put my hands on a female is something that's
You're protecting the mother of your child.
So, okay, I'm gonna phrase it in a different way, though.
Okay.
You can't.
Let him.
That a possible mother of another child, I can't put my hands on them.
You ain't thinking
she
about
attacked
that.
The woman.
That's not the question I'm asking.
Because
that woman also could be a mother of somebody else's child.
Fair enough.
So whatever misunderstanding
that could happen. She keeps her motherly hands to herself.
I get that. But in my perspective, I'm thinking the same way. If she is a mother of somebody else's child too, me saying that from thinking that I cannot put my hands on her, but I'll have it taken care of later. How unfair is it?
How are you going to take care of it later when you don't even know who the woman is? This is a,
what, in The Sopranos?
We're saying that it's a random attack. How do you know who the... How are you going to take care of it later when you don't know who
it is? We're speaking on perspectives of different. This situation that started was something that was known. This woman was in room 405. You see what I'm saying?
Right.
And 405 would have been dealt with after.
So is there any instance in where you would react and I'm not saying like... We want people to out, like we don't. We want men out here hitting women. That's not what we're asking. We're just asking a hypothetical where, if we're with our significant other and they get assaulted, is it okay for us to?
Please, women, and not keep your damn hands to yourself when it comes to my people. That's that. Period.
There's other ways we can handle it. I'm sorry, I can't do it.
Here's a free phone. service.
Call. We were at your house ready to brawl with the whole
class. We're dudes. We're dudes.
But still.
The it was a police officer cop that decided to come into my property.
There was 10 dudes on your block.
There was
no female. Michael Jackson jacket.
There was no female. We can't compare that.
We called them out.
There was no
woman. I said, bro, moonwalk your ass back to where you came. We called them out.
There was no woman. There was no woman. How can you compare that?
We got jumped as teenagers.
Okay, by men.
And handled it.
By men.
But if someone touches your whiz, this is where you're Martin Luther King.
No, if someone touches my, if it's a dude.
No, that's not what he's
saying.
No. You can't say that because he's comparing sequences of events with men.
I know he's doing. You're right.
You can't compare.
You can't compare because it's the confrontations that you guys have had have been with men. So there's no conversation about whether it's fair or not to hit men. Obviously, we're both
an attack
both men.
On your whiz or your man is an attack on you. You guys are one.
Oh wow.
You know what? Let me tell you something. I admire you.
Stop.
You put it right here.
Let's go to break, please. Oh my God! When those two start bonding,
this
really in trouble. Maxwell's
gonna
be taking off the Coontree. Maxwell, you're making a strong
cable.
Any other comments about this whole situation?
Antoine says fights in the hood ain't fair. You damn right. Y'all want peace and love. I moved to Rosedale. War. This is war.
I moved to Rosedale.
No, it's not. Fights don't happen in Rosedale.
Gope says, Voice has a lot to lose in a legal battle. Kind of understand why he wouldn't.
But you're not. What do you have to lose?
First of all, like I understand what he's saying, but when heat of the moment, you're not thinking about circumstances, or you're not. They're like,
I'm thinking about Joe Brown. Like, yeah, you're trying to say yours.
You're not thinking about that.
Not saying that you guys would, but people start getting comfortable with stuff like that, and then if a confrontation, I'm not saying you guys.
Right, I'm not saying you guys,
but that's how situations get us.
They start walking around, start punching women in the face. Hey, get out my way.
You could anything could happen. You could remember that one day that female came and said, psh, and all of a sudden now, just in case anything could happen, all of a sudden it feels like just make that first move. I can't put myself in that circumstance or predicament. I'm sorry. I can't do it.
Look at you.
Well, good for you, man.
I know, right?
Yeah, right. Good for you.
In other news.
This bathroom won't use itself.
We'll be right back. Sunday morning breakfast.
Hi, I'm Layla Ali. I might be undefeated in professional boxing, but there's one problem even I can't fight alone. Childhood hunger. Over 17 million kids in America may not know where their next meal is coming from. That's one in five children. Yet billions of pounds of surplus food produced right here in America just get thrown out every year. That's more than enough to feed every last hungry child. That's why the Feeding America nationwide network of food banks gathers surplus food and gets it to hungry kids before it goes to waste. But they can't do it without your help. Join me in supporting Feeding America and your local food bank by going to feedingamerica.org. Together, we can knock out hunger. Together, we're Feeding America.
To help solve hunger in your community and to find your local food bank, visit feedingamerica.org. Brought to you by Feeding America and the Ad Council.
It only takes a minute to find out if you may have prediabetes. And you can do it at doihaveprediabetes.org. But you're probably not going to. Nope. I'm sure you've got a perfectly good excuse. Kids, work. I get it. You're busy. So what better time than now? Let's begin. Raise one finger if you're a man. Ladies, none yet. Oh, count in your head if you're driving. Now, three more fingers for everyone over 60, two over 50, one over 40, one more if you're not physically active, another finger if anyone in your family has type 2 diabetes. Another if you've got high blood pressure. If you're overweight, raise another finger. Two if you're very overweight. And three if you're really overweight. You've just taken the world's first audio prediabetes test. And if you're holding up five or more fingers, visit doihaveprediabetes.org or talk to your doctor. There's no excuse, because prediabetes can be reversed.
Brought to you by the Ad Council and its Prediabetes Awareness Partners.
It may be hard to believe, but people just like you are already saving money. Feedthepig.org makes it easy. Their simple savings plan teaches you how to start saving without going overboard, so you don't need to mooch off your friends.
You gonna finish that grape?
You mean the one in my mouth?
You don't need to stop buying the necessities.
What you're smelling is a natural musk.
Ew.
You don't need to be a medical test subject.
How do you feel?
Mostly okay. I... Sometimes, though.
You don't need to get a second job as a stuntman.
We need a new stuntman!
You just need an internet connection. Don't get left behind. Start your personal savings plan with the tips and tools on feedthepig.org. That way, you don't need to sell your soul to the devil.
$15 is the best I can do.
All right, deal. Brought to you by the American Institute of CPAs and the Ad Council.
It's Thursday night, and you're grabbing drinks with some friends. Started off with a pitcher for the table, which quickly becomes two. There's pool. And there's the photo booth.
All right, everybody, squeeze in. Say cheese!
Followed naturally by an order of wings. And another.
Can we get some extra ranch sauce?
Then there's the ceremonial nightcap.
So what are we doing this weekend?
And lastly, it's back to the car, which, if you're buzzed...
6-8-10-4.
Could be the most expensive night of your life. Getting pulled over for buzz driving could cost you around $10,000 in fines, legal fees, and increased insurance rates. Nothing kills a buzz like getting pulled over for buzz driving, because buzz driving is drunk driving. Brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration and the Ad Council.
Are you Sunday morning breakfast. Oh, I'm gonna call us at 516-900-2278. Thanks for watching and not beating women. Jesus Christ. Got so heated in here. Oh, Chris, I'm going to punch you in your face. Whoa. So this guy on Twitter, man, he really dissected the Remember the Times Michael Jackson video very thoroughly. And, I mean, everybody remembers Remember the Time. I mean, the video was epic. Let's not forget how it was premiered, I think, after The Simpsons.
One of his best videos.
Yeah. Yes, after The Simpsons on Channel 5, we all remember. And we all had to watch. It was dopeness. But somebody decided, he goes by the name of... at NY underscore wise ass. His username is The Angry. And boy, does he stay true to the name. So anyway, he dissects the video by referring to Michael Jackson as an asshole in the Remember the Times video. And he brings up some great points. All right. So throughout, there's a lot of tweets on this anyway. He starts out by saying, Pharaoh ain't deserve any of the disrespect. Queen had an attitude the moment the video started, which is true.
That was Iman, yes.
Iman, yes. Who, she was gorgeous. She was a beautiful... Eddie Murphy was the king.
Yes.
And first off rip, she requests some entertainment. She's like, I need to be entertained. And
like, you remember who the... her hand and shit.
Yeah. And remember who was the presenter. You remember who that was?
Magic
Johnson, yes. That's right. Talking about, I want to be entertained. Can my Pharaoh find some way to entertain his queen? He then proceeds to say, Pharaoh be real, be a real nigga that he is, claps his hands, and entertainment appears. He says, how the nigga supposed to know that Queen used to fuck with a magical piece of shit?
She got 2,000 likes, too.
Yeah, what was the relationship like between Michael and the Queen? Like, what was that about? Because you remember, he comes in the whole robe covered up, mm-hmm. and then he becomes dust. if I'm Pharaoh, I would have stabbed MJ the second he uttered fell in love. That's real. Michael Jackson walked into a pyramid and went down memory lane with Pharaoh's wife. Bitch. I was thinking about this. He's surprised how, remember Michael Jackson walked up the steps and straight did some voice shit and kissed his hand?
Mm-hmm.
Her hand, excuse me.
And dance walked at that. Usher dance walk shit that, you know, that they do. Yes.
He says, how does nigga get this far? Michael Jackson walked into another man's living room and seduced his wife in the middle of ancient Egypt. Hmm. Would have executed him the second I seen this. Referring to Iman's face when she first sees Michael Jackson.
Correct, yes.
Now this nigga dances through all the rooms of the pyramid like shit is a joke. Oh man! Again, the pyramid dancing with Mike. MJ talking about, do you remember Spade? I know that shit echoes through the crib.
Wow.
And yo, MJ talking about, do you remember Spain? I know it echoes through Spain. Do you know how far Spain is from Egypt? Are you kidding me?
No, and they showed the map.
Oh my god!
I need this guy to dissect every video from now on. It is 2017. He took her to Spain before Christ.
Wow.
He said, nigga yelled, brat, that, in other words, in another man's house.
I got 7,000 likes. Oh my God.
I'm the only nigga allowed to yell, brat, that, in my house. Yell that shit. Oh, yell that shit if you want. You ain't leaving my house safely. Got me fucked up. Matter of fact, why are you yelling at all in my house? Oh, I'm sorry, in my pyramid. On the phone, you and me till dawn, till three. should have just, MJ should have been beheaded.
Mm. Wow.
And then he brings up another good point. Then you remember when all the his workers started dancing with Michael.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
He then says, there they go, this disloyal citizens. Really imagine a nigga walking to your home screaming, brah, asking your queen about Spain. Really imagine that. I'm going to jail if I ever experience that. I gotta watch this. I gotta watch this video a little bit differently now.
I think
it's somewhat. It was.
It's not the sweet song that it used to be. Yes.
I mean, it's still a dope choreography, though.
I mean, of course.
Yeah. And then he's upset that the servants knew the choreography. Like, how do they
like
know?
They've been practicing behind his back and shit.
Behind the back of the court, the king. Shh, the king's coming. He's coming. He's coming. Stop. Stop.
They start dusting.
So shout out to this guy, man. He was. This was hilarious. I don't know if he does this with other videos. Hopefully we can try to get him on the show or something like that. But he did a great job. And by the way, man,
remember we used to do that? We used to do the voiceovers.
Yeah, we did. But the problem
we didn't never wind up doing it.
We never. Well, the problem was that I was just concerned with I uploaded it once, and the rights of the music video, like they take it down ASAP. Yeah. So I don't know if there's a way we could get around it or what, but we'll figure out some way. I mean, I feel like we really need to do that because we had. I think I still have them.
The bad boy.
We
one.
Did
oh, yeah, bad boy.
We did tender love. Tender
I
Love
that
by the Force MDs, yes.
I love that song.
Yeah, we did that video.
And one dude was wearing the most ridiculous suit ever.
And they were sitting on a stoop looking like 227. It was just terrible.
Yeah, one dude looked like Charlie Brown.
Oh, my
with
God.
The yellow suit. Yeah, yeah.
One of them had like the Eddie Murphy hat from back in the 80s. Yeah, it was crazy.
Yep. I think we did Gotham City of R. Kelly. And he wrote, you remember Gotham City, R. Kelly, where it was the remix?
Yes.
And he was driving through the hood with the Batmobile.
And he had the ball girl rapping?
Yes,
oh,
yes.
That was my shit.
Gotham City. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
I think anything R. Kelly involved is funny.
Man, listen,
especially on Mr. Big videos.
Yes.
Especially now. By the way, did you see that video of him with the cigar? What was that about?
The cigar tried to kill him. I said on Facebook the cigar must have had an underage daughter. Somebody got mad at me.
It's totally disrespectful. I think a woman finally came up front and said, yeah, she's
16.
Yeah.
Said he spit on her, too. This dude checked every fetish box. Like, piss every. I mean, like, bro, pick a couple and live your life. Like, this dude, every weird fetish he's a part of. It's ridiculous.
Yeah. Accuser says R. Kelly paid her to hide underage relationship. I mean, we weren't upset with Aaliyah, though. None of us sat there.
I guess not.
Did the parents give Aaliyah permission?
I don't think she snuck out the window and got married, though. I'm not sure.
I didn't see the Lifetime special.
That's true. It was overseas.
Because they addressed it.
They addressed it, but I've never. You know what? I can't do Lifetime movies. I won't. But so I'm sure they addressed it in that, but I'm not gonna watch it. But I feel like they gave them permission to get married when she was 13. Or 14.
Ugh.
How old was she? 15. She was probably 15.
Because remember, he wrote Back and Forth.
And he wrote AJ Nothing But a Number.
Yeah. Of course.
Yeah. Like, that was a dead giveaway, obviously.
People never thought
he's
about that.
He's the one rapping on that. If you remember he's the one rapping on it. Sounded all kinds of awful. Yeah.
The accuser said that I was slapped, I was choked, and I was spit on.
Ooh. Like I said, every fetish this dude.
Excuse me. Oh my God.
You okay? Seemed like you got choked and spit on too. You all right over there?
She says, I know speaking out against Kelly could sue me, but I'm really not worried about him anymore. I feel like this is a healing process for me because I've been holding this in for so many years. And to see that he always gets away with it is just not right. I'm going forward with my head hell high.
Hmm. Mm. Well, you go, girl.
And then I started listening to Sex in the Kitchen right after that. It's really my song. I'm so sorry. I feel really, no, you know what? But now I feel ashamed when I like, because that's really my song.
So you still listen to R. Kelly, though?
I you know what? I went and
you just went on this whole tirade where we were all on your side.
I know. I had to be honest because I being on was like, I have a confession. He's like, what? I was like, I'm listening to Sex in the Kitchen. He's like, come on. I'm like, I know.
I gave her really quite the lecture.
I really have to not listen to him. Yeah. I really don't.
At least one of his like nice gospel.
Right.
At least I'm Your Angel, one of that foolishness. Don't listen to them nasty records.
My sweet 16.
What about
that's before we don't
yeah, it's getting a little bit weird.
I was there taking pictures crying.
Oh, yeah, he was there. Why did you bring Carl?
Again, this is before the video drops. This is so beautiful, Crystal and her father. Yo, not knowing.
Yo, Jim Brown might have a point, man. You can't do two things and be hypocritical, man. Jesus Christ. So you danced with your father to an R. Kelly song.
But we didn't know. That was before we knew he was a pervert. Exactly. We didn't know he was a pervert then.
This is like, what, 98, something
yeah,
like that?
Yeah, 99. Okay.
When did the allegations first come out?
Yeah, 2001.
Yeah.
So to be fair,
but to be
we just
fair,
knew
we
he was
know.
The weirdo that married yeah. me.
It was him and
yes.
Celine Dion.
I was there just.
Oh, my God.
Terrible. Yo, Corinne says, yes, the mother gave consent.
See, right.
But Maya B says, I thought they made her get it annulled when she got home. So, I'm
but how do you
when she got
that's
home?
That's the
you're in trouble, young lady. And you're grounded.
You go upstairs and get that marriage annulled.
And no TV for a week. Right. Wow.
How do you give them consent and then come back and be like, no, that's not gonna
maybe,
work.
No, maybe they didn't give consent.
R. Kelly got to get stoned, B. I'm sorry, yo. Like
yeah,
he's too
really
disgusting
bad.
For me,
like,
yo.
Yeah, he's really.
Even the way he was smoking that cigar was inappropriate.
I didn't see the video.
These dudes were weirdo. Yo, it was the biggest cigar. The cigar as big as this mic.
Yeah, it was
yo.
Really Paul's worthy.
Like literally, I'm like, Paul's what's in his mouth, and then he's smoking it, and he chokes out of nowhere. He's trying to be cool. He's trying to act like he's interested in women his age. And then next thing you know.
So wait, he's smoking and holding the phone and driving?
He's driving at the same time. Exactly. All kinds of dangerous. It's one thing for him to be reckless with these young ladies, but his own life? But anyway, so all kinds of dangerous, and then he just chokes out of nowhere.
But you know the crazy part? I've never heard of R. Kelly getting anyone pregnant aside from his wife.
Because they didn't report it. You don't know exactly what is happening.
Yeah, you don't know. Right? Yeah, you don't know if he has them going to a
but
clinic
I'm sure
or.
Somebody would have came out already.
Nah. No, I'm saying, how come he don't got herpes?
I'm right. Exactly. I'm pretty sure he'll come out in the next couple months.
So she says, if I could speak out, I can help them out, help them get out of that situation. That's what I will do. I didn't have anybody to speak up on my behalf when I was going through what I was going through. He's brainwashed them really bad, and it kind of reminds me of Charles Manson. For those who don't remember, Charles Manson was the guy who had the women and decided to go on a murder spree. I just really hope I can help these women out. Kelly needs to be stopped. And yet still nothing happens. Like,
nope.
Nothing. Oh, my homegirl Naya's on here. She's from the Philippines. Hi, Naya.
Nice.
What's up? Welcome. Wow.
Okay.
All right, we got to take a quick break, man. Yeah, we got to do more research on this. Jim Brown and R. Kelly, and it's been one of those shows, man.
Whew.
You can't live two lives, man. You can't be an activist and touch
and
an underage girl.
And listen, R. Kelly, I'm doing better.
And you could just delete the songs.
I mean, I didn't buy them.
They hard to delete. I ain't going to lie. I ain't buying. Excuse Slayer Row. I'm not buying any more music. But the old ones I brought, you know, before all this nonsense, yo, please. No need
so you can
money.
Still listen to 12 play the same?
Not the same.
Even I watched the I watched the Cosby Show yesterday, and there were certain scenes that I was just like, ugh.
I'm definitely more interested in Elvin scenes than
yes. Like the flirtation between him and Claire.
Oh,
it's
man.
A little bit weird.
Their little sex scenes or before sex scenes were ridiculous.
The way he used to kind of touch Denise was kind of weird as well.
But he feed her the apples and all this crazy shit. Cosby was a
it was all the signs
when
were there.
When he was eating them hoagies.
Oh my God! All the signs were there when you really look at it. The orange soda, the hoagies, the chips.
The orange soda.
Yeah, man.
Hoagies and chips. What are those signs of?
I don't know.
Signs wanting to eat. What are those signs of?
It was just very suspicious, man.
To you, yes?
The cake situation when he brought out all the cakes with the strawberry and...
Now that, because he that was feeding
Claire. But I mean, looking back at it, they were a married couple with all these kids. They was getting in somewhere.
Yeah, but it's just weird to watch it now knowing what we know now. Did you know that he tried to end the career of Dave Chappelle, D.L. Ugly, like everybody who was on that Def Jam roster?
Why?
Why?
Because he didn't agree with their brand of comedy.
No, too much cursing.
Yeah, he didn't like the fact that they used the N-word and curse. So he literally tried to end like those careers. He didn't want Def Comedy Jam going to HBO. So he called the execs at HBO and said, don't put that show on.
Wow.
Yeah. D.L. Ugly talked about it on Vlad TV. You should check it out.
I never forget, I interned at a radio station, and Cockroach came on.
Oh, yeah.
And he was doing the interview, and he called in and stopped it. And he left. He called in and stopped it.
D.L. Ugly said the same story.
He fired him.
No, he was sitting there getting ready to tell his story with a huge radio personality back in the day who remained nameless. And he came in, and he was talking. Right. He was talking, and they came in, and they were like, I don't know how he knew. He was like, and he left.
And D.L. Ugly said the same situation where they didn't get along. So D.L. Ugly was hosting a show. He excused himself from the interview, but Bill Cosby was being such a piece of shit that he interrupted and said, Bill, this is D.L. Ugly. What are you doing? Blah, blah, blah. They have an exchange. And apparently, right after the exchange, he calls the higher-ups at Emmis and says, take this. I don't ever want to see this interview ever aired, or nobody in your job will work in radio ever again.
You know what they say, man? Yes, it's good DeAndre that things Cole. Catch up to you. Yeah. And even with him maybe being an old good man, it's catching up to him.
Maybe him owning NBC would not have been a good thing.
Oh, my God.
Maybe that was a blessing in disguise. All right, Sunday Morning Breakfast. We'll be right back with sit-down segment of the week.
Adopt US Kids presents Multiple Choice Parenting.
Your daughter just had her first breakup. Do you A, put yourself in her shoes?
How could he do this to you? And for Sheila, she has split ends.
B, console her.
Oh, sweetie, this is going to happen a lot. 4, maybe 5 more times before you get married.
C, take charge.
Got to get this all straightened out. Keep a little talking to man, mano a mano. Hey, Steve, it's now a good time? No? Okay, no problem. Bye.
Or D, help her find a new boyfriend.
I know a great place to meet boys. The internet. Nice, single boys. Never mind. How about some ice cream?
As a parent, there are no perfect answers. But you don't have to be perfect to be a perfect parent. Thousands of teens in foster care will love you just the same.
For more information on how you can adopt, visit AdoptUSKids.org. A public service announcement from the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, Adopt U.S. Kids, and the Ad Council.
What's going on, everyone? This is The Voice, and you're now listening to the Sunday Morning Breakfast Radio Show.
You don't usually get a stock tip from a 16-year-old, but I'm here to tell you about a different kind of stock. It's called Better Futures, a stock for social change that's not about making money. Instead, you invest to help students like me go to college. This is beyond a simple donation. It's the opportunity for America to invest in its kids and take an active stake in the future of the country. The return on your investment isn't money. What you get back is knowing you protected our potential. So one day, that potential can grow up to become surgeons and architects, executives and engineers, people who can change the future just by being a part of it. My name is Alicia, and I'm your dividend.
Invest in better futures with UNCF. Visit uncf.org/invest. A mind is a terrible thing to waste, but a wonderful thing to invest in. A public service announcement brought to you by UNCF and the Ad Council.
Welcome back to The Dog Show. Up next, we have Satchmo. Satchmo is a member of the Shelter Pet Group.
That's right, a group known especially for their couch-snuggling, ball-chasing, face-licking, tail-wagging, backyard-hanging, and, of course, companionship.
And what breed would you say Satchmo is?
I'd have to go with maybe a lavish terrier-hound chihuahua-looking kind of mix.
Tremendous dog.
I'd also like to point out Satchmo's coloring, a white, gray, brown, black brindle, simply marvelous.
You know, it's such a treat to watch a dog like this.
Now, let's see him in action.
Look how he makes eye contact with his person.
That's actually known as the treat stare.
How intuitive. And now he appears to be excitedly turning in circles.
Ah, the happy dance, so common with this group.
And finally, the loving face lick.
It's great how he just gets in there and, well, licks.
Fantastic. But really, the best way to know an amazing shelter pet like Satchmo is to meet one.
Visit theshelterpetproject.org today. Adopt.
Brought to you by Maddie's Fund, the Humane Society of the United States, and the Ad Council.
Why don't you sit down and shut up?
What? Why don't I sit down and what?
I said, why don't you sit down and shut up?
Sit down and shut up!
Sit down and shut up.
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 Yeah, sit down segment for the week of, what's today, September 3rd?
Labor Day weekend.
Winners and losers for this week. Before we actually get to that, though, I just want to give, we're going to be doing it is the season finale of Power. So we'll be doing a live review, probably around 1 o'clock. I'm pretty sure we'll notify everybody before then. So watch out for that. It should be quite interesting since, the last episode of Power. A lot of people were upset because we weren't on and Power wasn't on, and that was certain people's routine, and they were not happy about that. So we apologize for that. But we will be doing a Power review show live. So check us out. You can also comment and share your thoughts on whatever, and please participate in that. So we look forward to that. All right. Anything else? Oh, and also it is what's the Labor Day weekend. Yes. Obviously, we have the parade out in Eastern Parkway. We have Juve. Please, everybody, please be safe. I'm dead serious.
Goes without saying, though.
Yeah, it goes out without saying. But listen, man, like certain things like that. For the past couple years, we've had incidences where people have lost their lives or wounded with ignorance or whatever. So can we just let's just have a great event. We already got eyes on us already. Just let's just have a great event. Enjoy the time. Rep your country. All right. Don't go out beating any women. Voice. All right. With your Haitian flag in hand. All right. just enjoy yourself. Have a great time. And we hope everybody's safe this weekend. All right. All right. Let's go to the winners. Who do you have as a winner, Bino?
So, situation happened in New Mexico where an alleged carjacker was beaten to a pulp by a trio of amateur football players in New Mexico after the thug tried to steal their car. I'm here for it. Let's show a picture of our lovely carjacker here, son.
Wow.
This is beautiful.
I'm pretty sure he didn't look like that originally.
This is beautiful. Y'all remember Martin after the Hitman Herds incident?
I don't want to fight no more.
Yeah. Yeah.
I don't want to fight no more.
Yeah. Now
that's the episode you remember, really.
Right, absolutely.
Right, Jesus Christ. Right.
If
Trini
was about that,
I would have won. Yes.
You'd have showed Trini Man who's a man.
Absolutely.
Yes. That's right. But either way, this is beautiful, man. I almost made this my profile picture on Facebook here, man. Look at this.
He gets the profile picture.
I love it. Look at his face.
Wow.
That's what the hell he is.
They turned him Asian.
So, yes. So the winners are those trio of amateur football players as they were referred to.
That is crazy. Oh, my God.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Who is your winner of this?
So we talked about it already, but I have to give it to Colleen Dagg. I'm sorry. There's nothing to me like a hardworking woman, but a woman that
would defend
her man.
Crystal, you were taking the same winners, right?
Yes. We were supposed to do this together.
Yes, well, I was going to tell Crystal, Crystal, you could definitely tag along. I mean, so you definitely can speak to
just
it.
Don't beat her up.
As a female. But to me, there's nothing but nothing better than a woman that would defend her
Colleen
man.
Colleen Dagg is bae, okay?
Yes.
Bae.
Right. And she looks good.
My winner goes out to... the people that went to the NFL office, we were off, so we weren't able to speak on it. But it was funny, man. A lot of people showed up, and certain radio hosts in New York City referred to them as idiots and so on and so forth. But they went there to represent a certain cause. I don't find idiotic at all.
There was no violence.
They were, and this whole idea of why aren't people working? It was around 5 o'clock, so people usually get out around that time. So don't give me that crap. And they were actually standing up for a great cause. And one thing that was said was, you know what, you have all these people at Black Lives Matter who didn't donate to the police officer who got killed recently. Well, I don't know how somebody would not know that or how they would know that if they didn't donate it or not. But shout out to all everybody who went to the NFL offices to have their voice heard. And look, I don't know where it ends. I don't know how we, because you're still not watching the NFL, correct?
No.
I'm going to watch the NFL through the Fire Stick, so it doesn't count as a rating. There you go.
I'm sorry.
Way to show them.
Yes. Damn right.
Ladies and gentlemen, we do not promote any type of piracy, okay? We do not promote piracy. You don't know what he's talking about.
So since a few weeks ago, right? Since a few weeks ago, I say, y'all, I'm not watching it. Every time me and Preach speak throughout the week, you're still on for a while. Like, I knew he was less and less with the movement as time went on. Then he starts bringing up new ideas. So what if we go to Buffalo Wild Wings and it's on while we're in Buffalo Wild Wings, but we're just getting chicken, right? If we take a bite of the chicken and look up at the TV while it's on, does that count? Like, he's getting worse and worse with it.
You got me crying. Oh, my goodness.
Sister Preach, there's no kind of activism in your family. None.
I think Preach got the loser of the week.
Maybe Chase is about that life, but Preach is not about that life. Period.
No.
Oh, please.
It's okay.
But to be fair, they cannot count me watching an NFL game through the Fire Stick.
They count your satisfaction.
No.
You'll be able to talk about the game.
It's not counted as a rating.
You shouldn't know about the game, period.
What do you mean? I shouldn't know about the game.
Damn that.
You're going to do research on what happens in the game.
Buy the papers. Yeah, but you've got to be a person of detail to know exactly what happened in the game.
Yeah, but I could watch the channels in some type of way. I don't know what they do with the Fire Stick.
We don't know. We don't know what you're talking about, B.
Where's that blurred?
If this were a car and I was on a highway driving 80 miles an hour, Preach would open the door and roll out the car. Preach is never with me with this whatsoever.
Yes, I am.
I'm
still with you.
Madam Preach doesn't know what you're talking about either.
I'm still with you.
Yes.
All I'm saying is if you still want to enjoy NFL football, but you don't want to give them your rating.
And he's giving them a plug on top of that.
He even asked me. He's like, so the first game of the season. Which is tradition. You don't go to Wild Wings and watch it like a family. Yes.
Yo, the face Crystal gave me on the side was just disgusting.
It's called disappointment and rage mixed together.
No, you know what? I'm on the team. I'm not watching.
Man, get out of here.
Yeah.
I'm not watching. Out of
here. Corinne's gonna wake up at 4 o'clock in the morning. He's gonna be looking at everyone like,
yo, Corinne's gonna come in the room and think he's watching porno on a computer, but it's gonna be the Giant game. What's the Odell Beckham deal?
Hey, so what's going on?
What are you doing in here?
Nothing. Watching porn. Leave me alone.
Doesn't anyone knock around here?
Stop watching me. Leave me alone. All right.
Turn
off the TV.
Yeah,
man, I'm with the movement, man. I'm with the movement.
Yeah, you are
right out the car.
Exactly.
Yeah,
right. And watch the game. And straight to piracy.
Nah, well, listen.
You can through people's windows like,
at the end
of what?
At the end of
the neighborhood watch is going to have a complaint. That Albinor house, they keep looking through our windows. The hell's wrong with them?
Listen, at the end of the day, it doesn't count as a rating. It doesn't.
Yeah.
We had talked about not watching it together.
Malcolm would have loved you.
I definitely would have been on the other side.
He would have been all drinking out of the white only, out of black only water fountains.
I'm thirsty. Like, no.
I would have been, hey, man, listen. Am I now in the coon train? What the hell's going on?
We're going to take a vote.
I think you got loose of the week, sir. Just saying.
What? Oh, we're definitely taking a vote.
No, man, it's not. I thought.
Hey, Crystal, Maxwell's getting closer and closer off this trail.
The fact that I thought it through and I knew, I said, "Listen, I don't have to watch it on real TV. I could watch it on the Fire Stick."
Hey, what was there to think about? We're not watching it. We're not watching it. End of discussion.
All right,
nothing's changed. But you over here, you want to back up?
But at least give me this though.
No, when? I'm not giving you anything.
No. But when do we start watching it again? Exactly.
We haven't figured that
exactly.
out yet. But we said that we haven't
exactly.
figured out yet.
Excuse
okay.
you.
There's still no conclusion of watching
they didn't
yet.
Know when the bus strike was going to end in the
Yeah, Crystal. With that bullshit. Yeah,
right.
Crystal.
No, they knew bus strike when they were able to sit in the back of the bus. Right? Right.
In the front of the bus, not the back. We already said
I mean,
the back
in the,
bus.
I'm sorry, say in the front of the bus, right?
So we're not going to figure it out. It's going to be a day by day thing. And then when the conference
case by case, absolutely.
Yes.
We got to figure out day by day.
Excuse us for not giving you an itinerary.
Okay, look at this. You want to watch football? There's college football already out.
No, I'm not watching college football.
Come on. You got to support the youngsters, brother.
All I'm saying is I'm with you guys.
No, I
in the room, yes.
I feel it.
I just want to know when it ends. What is the event?
We have not figured that out yet, but all we know is we're going
to
strike.
We have to figure that out. What?
You could pick a Sunday to play football with your team.
Yeah, we can tell
who's
not
going to
make it.
Exactly.
We can tell who's not going to make it.
All right, man. Let's
lose it. Where
we at? We're going to start blaming it on the dog because he changed the channel. He gave me the remote. Like, no.
It was changed. It was on PBS, right. I swear.
Oh, my God.
Who's your loser for this weekend?
Yeah.
Besides me.
So, besides you, a professor, a black professor, gets suspended for saying that Black Lives Matter group should be hung. Check his name out. Professor Toby Jennings.
Oh my God.
You can't. He was born to be a coon. Like, Toby.
What's your name?
Like, super.
Yo, you can't make that up.
Okay, his name is Toby Jennings of Grand Canyon University.
Wow.
Ignited a firestorm recently after the university posted a link to a ministry forum from last September in which he said that some members in the Black Lives Matter group should be hung. They are saying things that are not helpful in any shape or form of human dignity or flourishing, the African-American professor said during the forum, which was videotaped.
Wow.
Yeah. See, here's my thing with stuff like that, yo. Like, exactly, voice. Yes, it's right, yo. Okay. Absolutely sickening. If you think this about your own people trying to fight for a cause that benefits you, what the hell do you think of the Klan and any of these other groups, the Nazis and any of this other shit?
Right.
So because you can only, as a black man, can only speak about your own people doing something for you, you are my loser of the week, right after Preach. Wow.
Well, Corinne says Preach is on his way to sit in next to Jim Brown.
Yo, man, listen.
Preach is on that coon train.
Good boy. We have to shout out Crystal. Crystal said it's her first time watching the show.
Oh, that's my homie. Hi, Crystal.
Definitely.
Voice, who is your loser?
I'm going to give it. I'm sorry. I don't usually do this, but I got to give it to Cop 6 Sweepy. This week, they've taken an L. So we got the Utah situation that's going on. We have the cop that was, I think it was in BK, I believe, that shut down the barbecue because of...
Oh, Harlem.
Oh, it was Harlem. Okay.
I thought it was uptown. Okay, it was Harlem.
So it was uptown. So that situation is going on. And then afterwards, we have another video, the footage of, you know, saying that you have to be black in order to be killed. I don't know what it is. I don't know if it's veterans or anything like that, but I'm really hoping that the youth that's going to be part of the association, even though they got effed up pensions, they would make a difference with this community. We need some type of change of influence because it's going to get worse before it gets better.
Yeah. All right, Crystal, who is your loser besides me?
My loser of this week, as a proud West Indian, goes to the weather of New York City that sucks right about now.
I told you someone took LA.
So you're basically blaming God.
I'm not
Summer took a leave of absence.
Who controls the weather?
Summer took a leave of absence, and I'm very... excuse me, can I finish my... I thought we were getting along. Are you upset
you put me on a coon chain with Jim.
We just said that we were agreeing with each other.
You heard it. We were taking a vote.
We had an agreement, too. What happened?
This weekend's supposed to be about partying, about fun, and I need a jacket. And I'm just not having
it. It's hoodie season, baby.
A little bit early.
Yeah. Yeah.
No, definitely not.
My loser, and I don't even know what their stance is. So the Cleveland Police Patrolmen's Association, they have said this week that they are not holding the American flag as planned for the Browns regular season opener because players knelt during the national anthem during a preseason game this month. When management allows you to do those things, then it's on them. It's hypocritical of the Browns management and ownership to want to have an armed forces first responder day and have us involved in it when they allow their players to take a knee during the national anthem. That's very that's very representation of what we stand for. That's why we aren't going. So you're not going to hold the American flag to protest people kneeling for the national anthem?
It's getting more and more ridiculous.
That's the dumbest shit I've ever heard.
More and more ridiculous.
Oh, man. Now I see why people aren't going to watch the NFL.
Which you're going to...
Watch. I'm not watching it.
Indirectly.
Technically.
You're going to watch indirectly, yeah.
I'm not watching it.
Okay.
I thought you were going to try to listen to it on the radio or something like that.
Like, no.
I guess this fire stick idea is a better idea, yes.
Much better.
98.7 is going to be in his car.
It already is.
Actually, it's 101.9. But it doesn't matter. All right, let's get out of here, man. Let's do our shout-outs.
I'll begin. Okay, so shout-outs to... Oceanside, of course, Oceanside. Shout outs to Hunter and the family and the Dixon family who's going to be taking out to his first powwow. Shout outs to Case Consulting Media. Shout outs to my boss, Stephen Larry. Definitely came through big with me this week. And also shout outs to my workout partner. His name is Greg Lorge. Greg Lift, IBB Pro. He just got his pro card, winning second place in the competition. So some serious congratulations to you. I'll see you Monday.
All right, Crystal.
How can you follow that up?
I can't, right?
That was amazing.
I want to give a shout out to Big Zaddy. He took me on a surprise vacation. So we had a great, great couple of days together. We explored two countries. I love you so much.
Part one.
Wow. Instead of this background, she got a violin next time when she's like,
oh my God. Go ahead.
Anyway, shout out to Sweet Mama. Shout out to you Trumps on the street ever try to step to us crazy. But anyway, yes. Shout out to Sweet Mama.
It's a being like Contra.
Y'all want no problems. But anyway, yo, shout out to the homie Edgar, man. He's on the thread. Antoine Fisher. He a wild boy. He know what I'm talking about, man. He definitely disturbed the peace on Facebook this week. Shout out to VSU. Y'all crazy, man. And shout out to Leslie showing us love and Crystal
Leslie.
London. Shout out to my people. And that's that.
Shout out everybody, all the listeners. Shout out the family. Shout out my sister for watching and being part of the show.
Yes, welcome. Glad to have you.
Shout out everybody else. Shout out the family. Shout out Chase Face. Shout out the NFL. Illegal package. Shout out.
Yo, what's the new engineer we had in here?
Oh, shout out Jesse, man. Jesse, yeah.
Shout out to Jesse, man.
He'll be around.
I don't know if he's coming back, but yeah. To have him for today at least.
I don't know,
can
man.
We shout out old engineer too?
He's I know, right? Like, shout out to Chopped Liver on
there. Yeah, definitely. Yeah.
Boris, I got you, Boris.
And shout out the offended engineers here.
Have his ass when it's time to pay him. How about that?
Don't
be generous with the shout outs. When it's time to pay him, be generous with that.
Boris,
I got you.
Boris, bitter.
She know how to shout me out.
She don't know how to pass me my money.
Exactly. Yeah, here you go, Boris.
Shout out, wow. Yeah, man.
That's for this weekend, last week.
Yeah, for real.
I wasn't here last week.
I was just saying.
Nobody was here last week.
None of us was. I don't know why you gave him two.
Yeah.
Well, you know she got paid for the lost quarter.
Yeah, for the week before.
Yeah, exactly. That's back pay, yes. Boris, you keep that money,
Boris,
man. You earned it.
You're getting retroed.
Oh, man. All
right,
man.
Boris, you know I'm the only one to stick up for you in here, right?
Hey, like payment. I said, don't stick up. Stick in his wallet. Okay? Boris, I got you, B.
Shout out to all the women not hit by the voice. So let's shout out to And yeah, man, that's it, man. Sunday morning breakfast. We'll be back next week. We out of here. Peace.
Easy.